Fox Paris Fort Smith.
Here's what you want to tell me, Coach. Thank you for paving the way for line coaches to become head coaches. And he had told me that in the SEC meeting. We talked about a couple of things. He wanted to know how COVID was. I said, we're fine. He said, okay, man, we're going to be ready to play. And I congratulated him on what a great job he was doing.
Hey, this is Darren McFadden. You're listening to The Morning Rush.
Live from the Busch Light Studios.
You're causing a major disturbance on my time.
If I'm here and you're here, doesn't that make it our time?
On your favorite Arkansas sports talk station. Streaming live from
hitthatline.com.
There's a lot of lions, tigers, and bears, but they even one Razorback. Number one.
This is The Morning Rush.
Borderline erotic.
With Ty Richardson.
I'm shy.
That's cool. I can dig it.
And Tommy Kraft.
Do I look happy?
What's wrong?
Lloyd!
The Morning Rush starts right now.
So we've been talking about connections with when Arkansas opponents, whether it was Georgia and Sam Pittman and Kirby Smart, whether it was Lane Kiffin and Kendall Briles. Well, another connection has popped up, and this may not be head-to-head or former coaches together, but with Ed Ogeron as a former defensive line coach, he is one of the reasons that Sam Pittman is your head football coach today. Not anything he necessarily did directly, but indirectly. I mean, this is one of the few guys that went from a defensive line or an offensive line position, not being a coordinator or anything like that, to becoming a head coach. And his success, I think, gave Hunter Yurcheck some background and some validation saying, hey, this could work at Arkansas as well. It is a Recruiting Thursday here on The Morning Rush. We are live at World of Wireless here in Barling. Come by and see us this morning. And we are brought to you by Breeden RV. They are having their last sale right now in Van Buren. And despite everything going on, they're still getting in new trailers weekly. And they are marked down as soon as they hit the lot. These are brands you know and brands you trust. Forest River, Dutchman, Thor, Coachman, and so many more. The great thing about Breeden RV is your new purchase comes with free maintenance for life. Let's say you want to put away your trailer RV for the winter. They can do that too. Winterization special starting at just $99. Plus, they'll work on all makes and models. Ransom and his staff will make sure that you're well taken care of at Breeden RV. The Breeden RV Center in Van Buren, your friends in the RV business. So it's cool to hear Ed Ogeron on the SEC teleconference yesterday mention what Sam Pittman had to say to him at SEC meetings, and then as well just talking with him in the conversation. You know that Sam Pittman is very appreciative of what Coach Ed was able to do at LSU, because I think he knows he wouldn't have the job at Arkansas without him, maybe a Mario Cristobal and some other guys that kind of took that first step as either offensive or defensive line coaches.
Well, there's definitely some merit to that, and absolutely you needed someone to go and be the first to plant the flag as an O-line coach or a D-line coach or a non-coordinator and have success. I mean, the reason Ogeron was successful, and remember, he wasn't successful at Ole Miss. You know, he had to go and fail once to have a chance.
Saying,
you
know, the Hummer commercial wasn't successful?
Know, no, I'm saying he wasn't successful as a head football coach. He didn't win games.
You're putting it lightly. They sucked.
He got fired.
You're
now
putting it very lightly.
But you know what he did? He recruited well, and he set the table for Houston Nutt to go in there and win a couple Cotton Bowls, get to a couple Cotton Bowls and be successful. And then when Houston Nutt ran out of his recruits, he failed. So why has Ed Ogeron generally been successful across his career as an assistant and now a head coach? Because he can recruit well. And I think that's one reason Sam Pittman has been successful over a quarter century of coaching college football is he's a good recruiter because he builds good relationships. And, there's a lot that goes into being a head coach, but, having a good base of recruiting and being able to have a good system for recruiting is key to no matter where you come from as a head coach, and that's the tie that really is the connects the dots with both those guys.
It's an admirable quality for sure that you have to have as a head coach in the SEC, and the line play on both sides of the football, both Sam Pittman and Ed Ogeron both understand how important the line of scrimmage is in this league. Now, their backgrounds, Ed more on the defensive side of the football, and then Sam Pittman on the offensive line and the offensive side of the football. They're coming from I guess, two different sides of the ball, but they still understand, again, the trench warfare that occurs in each and every Southeastern Conference game is vitally important. But it was cool to hear Sam Pittman and Ed Orgeron speak to that yesterday. And we've talked about personal connections as far as former coaches with each other. You have the brother-in-law between Jeff Libby and Kendall Briles, or Jeff Libby, however you say his name. But this is kind of a different connection, but it's still a connection nevertheless. And I know that Sam Pittman is very grateful, and he's earned it to this point, obviously, based on where their record is. But I'm curious to see just kind of what kind of reception you see from them at the game. This is going to be a fun football game, I think, come Saturday. I know that we've talked about Tom Murphy's report. He's going to join us later in the show at about 8:45. Richard Davenport's going to join us at 8:05 this morning. And then we're going to have on Eric Musselman this morning at 7:15. He's going to talk about Isaiah and Mace, Isaiah getting drafted last night, and then Mace getting picked up as well, which was a conversation we'll table to next segment. But we got a loaded show this morning. Again, we're live at World of Wireless. Come by and see us. Got an action-packed show this morning full of football and basketball content to get to.
Yeah, and I will tell you, we're going to talk about the NBA draft, which is not my wheelhouse, more your wheelhouse. But I think one thing that our listeners will find interesting, I've sure found it interesting, kind of flipping back and forth. Now, you were probably glued to the NBA draft. I was dipping in, dipping out. I wasn't finding the in-between picks of analysis and the conversation probably as interesting as you. But, you know, I was watching for our guys. I wanted to see, you know, particularly when we got around 21 where we thought maybe one of the guys would sneak up and get in. Well, obviously, you know, Mason Jones wasn't part of the plan like we were hoping he was. And I didn't stay up late enough to see Isaiah Joe, but boy, was that great news when we woke up. But one thing that became very clear was, boy, the SEC is heavily involved in this draft. And I put a tweet out that, you know, four of the first 14 picks are from the SEC, and that trend continued through the night. Ty, none of those guys were from Kentucky in those first 14. So what's that tell you? Well, this league's deeper and it's better because of better coaching. We'll talk to Muss about that coming up. But, you know, your first four picks and none from Kentucky. Now, they caught up. They made up some ground later on, and it didn't take much longer for that. But 12 SEC picks in this draft, which was more than any other conference. It sounds like an NFL draft, but it wasn't. It was the NBA draft with the SEC leading the way.
And you think about it, so the SEC has both number one overall draft picks, Joe Burrow going to the Cincinnati Bengals, Anthony Edwards getting taken off the board first as well. So that's something also kind of cool as he ends up.
Let the haters hate.
Yeah, so that's just continuing on. And I know we've talked about so many times how dominant SEC football is, how dominant SEC baseball is. Well, now you've kind of got to put basketball at least in the conversation of having the best conference based on draft picks. We'll see what happens with this upcoming year, thinking how deep this SEC basketball conference is going to be. But really excited for a number of young men last night. There was a lot of trials and tribulations that if you did watch, which I saw our Twitter poll yesterday, 80% of people said they weren't going to watch and only 20% said they were. So we'll do some bits and pieces with Mason and Isaiah, but we won't necessarily dive into what occurred, a bunch of stuff last night, because it seems like that not a lot of y'all care about the NBA. But I think back to the LSU-Arkansas conversation, I don't know if I'd necessarily say that if Ed Orgeron doesn't have success that Sam Pittman isn't hired as the head coach, but there's just really not a lot of numerous examples that you can point to where a non-coordinator is hired as a head coach and there's a track record. I mentioned Mario Cristobal. I haven't mentioned Philip Fulmer. He's one. Ed Orgeron is one, but there's not a lot of notable names that you can point to and say, whoa, this is a great example that can be used in Sam Pittman's favor prior to hiring him.
But keep in mind, they tried to hire Lane Kiffin. They tried to hire Mike Leach. You know, at least that's the reports. Now, ADs are never going to come out and say, well, yeah, we hired our third choice, you know, or fourth choice. They're never going to say that, but they tried to hire other guys, and the job became Sam Pittman's, and it seems to worked out. And Sam Pittman's going to pave the way for other guys as well. We are live at World of Wireless, right at the light, next door to Frank Rowe Furniture in Barling. Ben's here this morning. Hey, we're proud of Ben. He's been here 25 years. Now, this is a new location. He hadn't been in this location. Only been here about 25 days. They've moved in here a little bit longer than that. But come by, say hello. They've been in business 25 years. Got some great gifts when you sign up for Dish this month. We're going to be telling you more about that. But 25 years in business, we wanted to come over this week and celebrate with him. Congratulations to Ben and his staff. We'll tell you more throughout the morning.
Coming up in the program, we will touch on where Mason Jones landed, where Isaiah Joe landed, and we'll get into some quick hitting headlines as well. Stay with us. It's the Morning Rush.
This is Recruiting Thursday on the Morning Rush, brought to you by Breeden RV, where your adventures begin.
Yes, sir!
If you have experience transporting frozen and refrigerated goods and want to be part of a trucking family with insurance and be home every week, you need to contact Brent Higgins Trucking. Since 1997, Brent Higgins Trucking in Mulberry has been proudly delivering to and from various areas of the United States, including but not limited to Oklahoma, Texas, Louisiana, and Mississippi. Brent Higgins Trucking, where you're a name, not a number. Contact them at 479-997-2366 or at BrentHigginsTrucking.com.
Tommy Kraft for The Fence Man. If you've always wanted powered automatic gates at your home or business, but you didn't know who to call, let me tell you about The Fence Man. 479-782-3936. The Fence Man does it all. Custom wrought iron installations, automatic gates, even controlled access systems, and lots more. Ask about 18-month, same-as-cash financing with approved credit. For your custom fence and gate needs, call The Fence Man. 479-782-3936. The Fence Man. He ain't afraid of no work.
0% financing for 84 months on all 2020 Buicks, GMC Terrains, and GMC Acadias at Harry Robinson Buick GMC. Get 0 for 84 months on the hottest selling Buick model, the Buick Encore, or 0 for 84 on the Buick Enclave, loaded with luxury and third row seating. 0% financing for 84 months on all 2020 Buicks, GMC Terrains, and Acadias at Harry Robinson Buick GMC. Exit 11 off of I-540 in Fort Smith.
Today is the day. After countless hours of research, cutting back expenses, and 9 months of anxiously waiting for her, today is the day you finally bring home your new car. It's also the day to protect her with an auto policy from Shelter Insurance. Our policies are competitively priced and include new car replacement coverage if anything were to happen to your new baby.
Ask Shelter agents Tiffany Newman or Warren Robertson about Renter's Insurance.
Art's Barbecue and Burgers has several new items they've added to the menu. Stop by Art's and try something new, like the El Diablo Burger, a spicy pork patty with grilled jalapenos, hot barbecue sauce, and pepper jack cheese on Texas toast. Or the all-new Smoked Philly Beef Sandwich, or the Patty Melt, and backed by popular demand, the 14-ounce Smoked Ribeye. Plus, Art's can handle all your game day homegating or tailgating menus. Try something new at Art's Barbecue and Burgers on Rogers Avenue next to Aaron's in Fort Smith.
The best TV experience in the nation is available locally with personal service from WOW World of Wireless, your neighborhood professional Dish authorized retailer. Dish has the Hopper 3, the most advanced DVR, and delivers a premium viewing experience. Tired of running out of DVR space? With the Hopper 3, you can record up to 2,000 hours of your favorite programming and watch your very own favorite channels and DVR recording anywhere you go on your phone or tablet. Call now WOW World of Wireless at 877-305-DISH. That's 877-305-DISH. 3474 for more details, or visit us online at shopwownow.com. Get the Hopper 3 today by calling WOW World of Wireless at 877-305-DISH. That's 877-305-3474. Or online at shopwownow.com.
Monthly equipment fees and other restrictions apply. Recording hours vary. 2,000 hours based on SD programming. Remote viewing requires internet connection and compatible mobile device. World of Wireless has moved just a few miles east, next to Frank Row Furniture in Barling.
Deer hunters, it's prime time, and the Deer Woods are the place to be. Jelco Outdoors has all the supplies and gear to make your hunt one to remember. Men's, women's, and children's boots and clothing to keep you warm and dry. Tree stands, scents, calls, safety vests, firearms, archery. Jelco has it all for you. Best of luck to all hunters. Stay safe, and remember, a great hunt begins at Jelco Outdoors, 4600 South Zero in Fort Smith.
Hi, I'm Kelly Smith, owner of Dixie Digital Imaging. Would printing from your phone or tablet make your life easier? Are you emailing files to yourself so that you can print them from your desktop or laptop? The Xerox VersaLink and AltaLink lines of network printers and multifunction printers will natively print using your phone's built-in capabilities. Apple AirPrint and Google Cloud Printing just work. To order yours today, give us a call at 783-6600 or visit dixiedigital.com. Dixie Digital Imaging, bringing document innovations to the River Valley.
Have your travel plans changed? Looking for a place that's close to home and keep your family safe? Gaston's White River Resort is located on the beautiful White River. They offer private accommodations in their lodges and cabins. Most cabins have a fully equipped kitchen, or let their restaurant staff deliver to your cabin. Call 870-431-5202 and change your plans to Gaston's White River Resort. Gaston's White River Resort, a first-class time. Every time.
ESPN 95.3. The Morning Rush with Ty Richardson and Tommy Kraft.
Mallard in the pocket. Throws it up over the top. Right on the front. Flash on. A breakaway. Colby Hamilton. 10-5. Can you believe it?
Follow the show on Twitter at HitThatLineAR and on Facebook and Instagram at HitThatLine.
Live at World Wireless, it's the Morning Rush. He's Tommy Kraft. I'm Ty Richardson. Going to get into what happened last night at the NBA draft. Some good stuff as we see one guy go get drafted from the Arkansas Razorbacks.
Brought to you by Trinity Multifamily, your teammate in the real estate game. If you own apartment complexes, duplexes, multifamily properties, you need the pros when it comes to managing that day-to-day, because you need to either move on to the next project or back to your day-to-day business. A lot of times these are owned by people that have other business interests, and multifamily properties is kind of the side investment, so to speak. Get the pros to manage it. That's Trinity Multifamily. They manage thousands of units in 15 different states. That's their expertise, is managing multifamily property. So they know how to vet the tenants by making sure that all the leases is right, going through the credit applications, going through the applications, all of the process of making sure the right people are renting your properties, number one, then making sure the paperwork is in line, making sure maintenance issues and all of the various things that go on day-to-day are handled, giving you access to that with an online portal you can log into, see financials, see pictures, and on, so you can keep up with your properties, and all of it's bundled up together in monthly reporting that you get, that's simple and easy. If all that sounds good to you, call our friends at Trinity Multifamily, 479-452-1817. That's 479-452-1817. Or read more about this great company online at trinitymultifamily.com. Trinity Multifamily, your teammate in the real estate game.
Here was Isaiah Joe going off the board last night.
Philadelphia 76ers select Isaiah Joe from the University of Arkansas.
So the rumor that we reported yesterday from Jonathan Wasserman or Bleacher Report was half right. It looked like the 76ers had promised Isaiah Joe a draft pick. Now the ones reported were their first two picks, but he ends up getting taken 49th overall and gets drafted. Now Mason Jones ended up signing a free agent deal with the Houston Rockets last night, does not get drafted, but good to see both those guys end up with an NBA franchise.
As a Fort Smith guy, you're grinning in your ear to ear to see a Fort Smith guy do well. Of course, Isaiah Joe played at Fort Smith Northside, and anytime someone from your hometown makes it to the big time. I mean, this is good. You think it's great when you just go to the University of Arkansas and you play well and you show out. Now this is even great when you get to the NBA and you follow in the footsteps of the biggest legend out of Fort Smith in this regard would be Ron Brewer Sr., who went to Northside and drafted very high. I think, sixth overall, if I remember right.
I think that's the highest Arkansas draft pick in history.
He played at Northside. So, I mean, kind of following those footsteps. Great tradition that Eric Burnett's captaining now at Northside, that Gail Condart once started back in the 60s and 70s over at Northside. So Isaiah Joe, just another one of those great players out of that great storied program. So Fort Smith can take a lot of pride in this selection last night as well.
Here's what Jay Billis, Jay Williams, and Mike Schmidt and Reese Davis had to say about Isaiah last night.
It's hitting about 34%, but he does have some range.
Yeah, he can score, and he played in a backcourt with Mason Jones, who's another big-time scorer. Jones averaged 22 points a game, but Isaiah Joe was in the draft, came out of it, went back in again. But I think he is a good shooter. You know, a little bit of a volume shooter, and he and Jones competed for shots a lot. But they played in an up-tempo system, so he knows how to play fast.
Yeah. You just wonder with Isaiah Joe, if the knee injury hadn't happened, would that Pickman 40th, 42nd, 38th, somewhere? I mean, how much did the knee injury and just the loss of the games maybe setting back, or did it no effect at all? I don't have the answer to that. I just ponder that question.
Yeah, because he missed, what was it, 5 or 6 games? Yeah. I always forget which one. So
5 games, I believe.
You think about how affected Arkansas was in his absence. Well, and
it may not be the missed games that might have put the pause on some teams and some scouts or whatever. Just the question about the knee, perhaps. But, you know, you wonder if he could have went from 49th to 5 or 7 or 8 slots higher if that injury had been avoided.
Well, guys, there was an interesting aspect to it. I think it was Kevin McPherson tweeted this out. There is a connection with Muss and the new 76ers head coach, Doc Rivers.
Right.
I think Muss was an assistant under him way back in the day. So there's that connection here. And for Isaiah Joe, yeah, he's going to a loaded team. And ESPN this morning before we came in here in the studio, they were complimenting the 76ers just how killer they did in the draft. They traded Al Horford away. They got a lot of young talent coming into Philadelphia this year.
Yeah. We'll talk to Mutz, going to be with us in about an hour. Did you say it's his birthday today?
It is his birthday.
Oh,
today.
So the birthday boy going to be with us in a little bit, about an hour from now. So we got a lot to ask him about.
Yeah, excited about that. And just to see, again, Isaiah and Mace both, and they did in different ways. Obviously, Isaiah Joe drafted 49th overall. Mason picked up the free agent deal. But I think both the Houston Rockets and the Philadelphia 76ers are getting NBA-quality built players who will be able to fill it up in different ways for both those franchises.
I guess there's a Daryl Morey tie kind of with both of them, the team he's was with as the GM and the team he's now with, I guess, for whatever that connection is worth. But I think Mason's going to make it work wherever he goes, because he's just going to work hard. Not that Isaiah Joe doesn't, but that's just been the work ethic that Mason Jones has put out has been pretty evident. And I'm disappointed for him that he didn't get drafted. I mean, it's obviously what he's worked hard for, but I think this will just fuel his fire even more right now.
See, I thought about that last night, and it would have been great for him to get drafted for the money reasons, the easier pathway to make a roster. But isn't this just the most Mason Jones way that he's going to make it at the next level? Like, we think about the days at Finley Prep, the days at Connor State, at Arkansas, still had some weight. I mean, this is one of those things where I think with Mason Jones, it's like you said, it's only going to fuel him even more, and that's going to – like, he put in all that work. The guy was the SEC co-player of the year along with Reggie Perry. He scored 22 points, led the conference. He had no – like, he wouldn't have been helped or abated by coming back, and, like, his draft stock would not have risen. So if I'm him, I was like, okay, I just did this in one of the top conferences in the league, and you're still doubting me? Okay, we'll see what happens. Well, yeah. Keep doubting my name. Keep doubting what I can do at the next level. And I think that's what people are going to continue to do, and he's going to continue to prove them wrong.
You know, there was not a lot of people questioning his decision to leave. There were some that wondered about Isaiah Joe. He decided to come back and then stayed for a number of days and then left again, right? Because the way the calendar set up, that was the way it worked. Well, now that decision to ultimately enter the NBA draft, hire the agent, go through the process, that's validated, right? I mean, you were drafted, you were taken in the second round. So now anyone that was looking at it, and there weren't many, but there were some that wondered, hey, is this exactly what he should have done? Clearly, Isaiah Joe made the right decision based on what happened last night.
Excited for both the young men as they look to continue on getting progressing and getting better at basketball at the next level, one with the Houston Rockets and one with the Philadelphia 76ers.
Hey, ready to take the next step with your career? If you want to make some real money, you need to call our buddies at United Welding Institute. You can average about $2,800 a week with United Welding Institute in Pottsville, 479-968-3390, or read more at unitedweldinginstitute.com. They're training great welders for the oil field, power plants, refineries, pipelines, and more. So seize the opportunity and take the next step towards a successful and essential career. That's 479-968-3390, or again, read more online at unitedweldinginstitute.com.
Coming up in the program, we will get into some quick hitting headlines. The betting line has shifted a little bit. And then what about LSU kids playing at Arkansas?
We're trying to outwork everybody in recruiting.
This is Recruiting Thursday on the Morning Rush, brought to you by Breeden RV, where your adventures begin.
Oatmeal again. Spectacular. Oven mitts for our anniversary. Truly spectacular. Double root canal. That's spectacular.
The new $1 million spectacular ticket from the Arkansas Scholarship Lottery has people thinking spectacular. Get the scratch off that can make you spectacularly rich surprisingly fast. Call 1-800-522-4700 for Problem Gambling Helpline.
Born in Arkansas, designed in the Swiss Alps, and field-tested all over the world, Canis Tactical Hunting Gear will allow you to hunt longer, farther, and in more comfort than ever before. Whether you are hunting early or late-season whitetails, chasing greenheads in the timber, or stalking elk in the west, our layering system has you covered. We're a direct-to-consumer company, so shop our website at canisathlete.com and use the code Arkansas to receive 15% off your first order. Follow us on social at canisathlete for updates and new product launches. Be the wolf.
Standard Materials Group has immediate openings for ready-mix drivers in the Northwest Arkansas area. If you have a CDL license without an automatic restriction and want to be home every night, want to work with a company that offers great pay, benefits, and a great team environment with growth opportunities, apply today at jobs.crh.com. Again, that's jobs.crh.com. Standard Materials Group is an equal opportunity employer.
Do you like paying rent or mortgage every month? Of course not. Thanks to real estate agents Nick and Ellie Glidewell and Chambers Bank, we're giving away free rent or mortgage payments for a year, up to $15,000. Now that's a good start to 2021. Go to hitthatline.com and enter the free rent or mortgage for a year sweepstakes now through December 14th. Complete contest rules are at hitthatline.com. Let us pay your rent or mortgage for a year, courtesy of Chambers Bank, real estate agents Nick and Ellie Glidewell, and ESPN Arkansas.
Do you have sleep apnea? Are you tired of dealing with a CPAP every night? The noise, the constant cleaning, your wife telling you she can't take the noise anymore. Dr. Bo Sparkman at Family Dental Care of Fort Smith can help you with sleep apnea with a custom dental appliance that allows you to get rid of that annoying CPAP. Dr. Sparkman has years of experience and has treated hundreds of patients just like you. Call for your appointment today, 785-1419. That's 785-1419. Get rid of your CPAP with Family Dental Care of Fort Smith.
Did you know that you can get your car serviced or repaired without ever leaving your house? All you have to do is call Jody's Auto Service Center at 479-649-3399. Jody's will pick up your vehicle, service or repair it for you, and return it fully disinfected to your driveway. Pickup and delivery is free for jobs $75 or more. Jobs less than $75 can be picked up and returned for a $10 fee. Let Jody's Auto Service Centers handle all your service and vehicle repair needs. Call 479-649-3399. Jody's Auto Service Center.
Watch every Hog game this season at Joe's Grill and Cantina, your home for half-price apps and taps during every Hog game. With TVs all around the restaurant, you'll have a front-row seat for all the action. Half-price appetizers like Joe's Sampler Platter, Ballpark Nachos, Tin Layer Dip, Brisket Nachos, and Mexican Pizza. And ask about Joe's tailgate packages to make your football experience even better in the comfort of your home. Half-price apps and taps for every Hog game at Joe's Grill and Cantina, 3400 South 74th Street, across from Harps.
Introducing Budweiser Zero. 0% alcohol, 0 grams of sugar. Full Budweiser flavor. For all the moments you want a beer and need to stay on your game. Budweiser Zero. 0 alcohol, 0 compromise.
When you're looking for outdoor power equipment, head to R-Track, where we've got the area's best selection of tractors and mowers. Check out our side-by-side UTVs, Argo Amphibious XTVs, and Hammerhead Go-Karts. We rent professional quality equipment and service everything we sell. Stop by today. Get the R-Track advantage.
Off I-40 at exit 58 at 219 East Taylor Road in Clarksville. You can check out their inventory online at rtrack.com.
This is Pastor Heath from Woodland. I know some of these ads make you glad, but most probably make you mad. The reason is people believe the lie that heals is better than the truth that hurts. Our purpose at Woodland is to risk the hurt by exposing the lies so you can be wise unto salvation. If you'd like to know more, check out our website, woodlandpeople.church. There you can download our app and listen to our podcast. That's woodlandpeople.church.
Frankfro Furniture Super Black Friday Blowout Sale. 2 p.m. to 6 p.m. Thanksgiving Day. 8:30 a.m. to 6 p.m. Friday the 27th. And 6:30 to 5:30 p.m. Saturday the 28th. For example, Catnapper Reclining Sofa and Love, regular $22.50, on sale finance price $18.22, cash price $16.70. Store-wide sale. All furniture, bedroom furniture, and mattresses on sale. 3 days only at Frank Row Furniture. Super Black Friday sale. Best seats in the house.
Tommy Kraft here. When it came time for new gates and some fence repairs at my home, the Fence Man was my first call. The Fence Man does it all, from large commercial jobs to small residential repairs. Wood privacy fence, vinyl fence, commercial or residential chain link, even custom wrought iron fencing. 479-782-3936. 18 months, same as cash financing with approved credit, is now available. If it involves fencing, the Fence Man does it. The Fence Man. He ain't afraid of no work. 479-782-3936.
You've been a longtime partner with us, and we really appreciate it. We're here and just glad to help you celebrate 25 years in business. That is amazing, number one, just because we know you, that you've been here 25 years. Number two, it's hard to do anything for 25 years. It's hard to stay in business. It's hard to stay married. It's hard to do anything in this world anymore, particularly when it's 2020 for 25 years. Man, we're proud of you. I know it's been a grind. Anyone that's been out there that's running a small business knows exactly what I'm talking about, and man, I'm happy for you.
It's been a tough year, but
you raise that mic.
We would have liked to have had a big party here and a big grand opening.
Yeah,
but we can, you know, with the COVID days, you just can't do that. We had it lined up to have a live hopper kangaroo here, not a mascot, a real hopper kangaroo, one of our customers.
Only you would have an actual kangaroo.
But, you know, we moved this summer. We're right next to Frank Row Furniture here in Barling. So
this is what your third location in 25 years.
Yes, third retail location. Now, we had a whole bunch of stores throughout the state.
You had a network, but your corporate
in
store.
In Fort Smith,
yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
So. Well, it used to be where Old Arts Barbecue used to be.
I mean, you think about over 25 years, the technology. I mean, you're in the satellite TV business, which has dramatically changed, but you started out in the cell phone business. That's dramatically changed. I mean, I was talking with my boss yesterday, and we're talking about some equipment. And I compared something. Hey, we're going from a bag phone to an iPhone when we change this piece of equipment out. And he thought, you know, you're exactly right. And I think about that now, just reflecting that conversation from 12 hours ago. And you started out selling bag phones 25 years ago.
Bag phones and giant handheld phones, but bag phones were very popular 25 years ago.
You know, you're
Ty's never seen a bag phone probably.
I probably not. I don't know what you're talking about at this point.
And now, you still do satellite TV, which they didn't have satellite TV.
We did satellite the first year. Fort Smith was a test market for Dish 1 year after we opened.
Wow.
They were one of four markets in the country with the small dish, went for those big 10-foot, 14-foot dishes.
Yeah.
That you see in the rural areas. So we were lucky and we were chosen. We just got lucky. Our rep walked in the door and we've been doing Dish ever since. They didn't have local channels back then on them. That was several years before you could even get locals. Now you can get every channel and every local channel in HD and 4K and smart homes with them. I mean, you can make your home smart just like you learned with the voice remotes.
Yeah. So, yeah, I made I'd been because of our friendship and partnership on DirecTV for a number of years. With all we've talked about with Dish, I moved my home to Dish and love it. And right now, if people will sign up for Dish as part of your celebration, I can just tell you this is great. The Google Assistant's great, but you're going to give a $100 Visa gift card and the Google Home Hub.
That's correct.
And if you don't have one of these, either an Alexa or a Google Home Hub or something like that in your home, man, you're doing it wrong.
It's easy. You just wake
up
in the morning.
You're doing it wrong.
Ask about the weather. You can also change your channels with the Google Hub. You can watch YouTube on the Google Hub. It integrates with it. And what's really great lately is you can integrate your cameras with the Hopper. So if you had kids out back or a pool or a large yard, you can have a camera in the backyard and be watching TV and up in the corner have your camera integrated with your Hopper system. And as far as I know, that's the only system that does it with the Google camera system for watching TV. But you can also watch your kids or whoever comes to the front door if you have one of the Google doorbell Nest programs with in your home.
All right, 877-305-DISH. We tell you that number every day, but call Ben, 25 years in business, people you can trust. Or if you're out this morning, you're on the east side of town in the River Valley, stop in, say hello. I know people are busy on their way to work, but we'd love to see you this morning, say hi. We don't get out enough anymore, and in 2020 we hadn't been out hardly at all, so this is close to the studio. We were just glad to be able to do this morning. So
I think the lines are forwarded right now because, but my guys will be up in a minute answering those phones.
So
I've got to deforward the lines.
All right, so come by, say hello this morning if you want to. We understand if you don't, but if nothing else, give Ben a call. But hey, thanks for being a great partner with us, and congratulations on 25
years.
Glad
you're here. Glad you're here.
All right, we'll talk some more later in the show.
Quick and headlines coming up here on the Morning Rush. I want to start with what Sam Pittman had to say yesterday during the SEC teleconference. He said, we are still within the number ratio and look forward to playing on Saturday. Now, Ed Orgeron, if you heard at the top of the show, they were having a conversation about this game, and he said he got a call from Sam, and they said they were looking forward to it, and the COVID numbers were good. So it looks like all hands on deck for Saturday as far as Hogs, Tigers, and we haven't gotten a report from the SEC office or an update on that. But at this point in time, they will be playing on Saturday.
But hold your breath because there's still more testing to be done.
Yep.
So, I mean, that's the thing. Good for now. I mean, you got to put the disclaimer in there. So, we know Missouri's, what, one player in the good, and I think is the report. That they have 56, and that's the minimum, is what I was reading yesterday. So, you're just holding your breath right now. Arkansas has been able, you know, for a while we were dodging the 11 a.m. games. Well, that's the least of your worries is what time you're playing. You just want to be
playing.
Yeah. So, I mean, let's hope that Arkansas has dodged the COVID bullet, so to speak. I don't know a better way to say it, but probably is. But you just hope to be able to just play these last three games without delay, without postponement. Right now, Arkansas does not have a game on the 12th or the 19th, so you've got some scheduling leeway, you hope. But, you know, LSU has one game on one of those weeks, so Missouri has a game. Alabama's going to play in the championship game, it appears. So the three games you have left have some conflicts already on those two games. So you need to get these things played kind of as scheduled to just make sure you get these three games in. And this one's important. Bama's important because they're home games.
Where do you stand on Pete Rose not being in the Hall of Fame?
I've never been one that was willing to be a moralist on this, that Pete Rose absolutely can't be in because he bet on baseball. And I think there's a lot of people that are in the Hall of Fame that they've got plenty of sins as well that they don't want bared out. So I think as gambling becomes more accepted, obviously more legal, that maybe the stance will soften on Pete Rose.
And the reason I bring this up is because he said in the last couple of days that he still bets on MLB games. The reason he is not in the Baseball Hall of Fame is because of him being caught and betting, and not betting against his team, but always, not always, but betting on himself on his team, which Phil and I disagreed with. I felt like, hey, he bet on his team. I'd bet on myself, too. I don't see the problem with that.
Well, it's against the rules. That's the problem.
Phil was pretty – yeah, but so was doing steroids, and there's plenty of players
that's my problem. I mean, if which sin's greater? I don't know. I mean, that's not for me to decide, but they're all of that was against the rules. So either let none of them in or let all of them
in. And that was the point I often brought up, but it was interesting to say that he, I guess, just doesn't care what people think because he said that he still bets – on MLB games, which I found kind of interesting. Look, his stats speak for itself. There's no doubt about that. But obviously that is the reason that he is not in the Hall of Fame.
He's at peace with the fact that he's not getting in. If he gets in at this point in his life, he gets in.
So. But I don't. What I don't want to happen is if after, because he's older, he passed and then they put him in.
That's exactly what's going to happen.
It's going to happen, but that's going to be irritating, I think, as far as Pete Rose is concerned. So we mentioned it last segment. Isaiah Joe gets drafted 49th overall to the Philadelphia 76ers. Mason Jones signs a free agent deal. Interesting text in from Chaz in Fayetteville, and he brings up a good point. With James Harden reportedly wanting out of the Houston Rockets organization, he's trying to make his way to Brooklyn, play with Kyrie, play with Kevin Durant. That's going to open up some scoring opportunity for a number of different players on the Rockets. Maybe Mason can slide in there and pick up that opportunity. He's not going to be Harden-level-esque in his first year, obviously, but if James Harden leaves that organization – they're going to need some scoring. What a great opportunity for Mason to try and slide in there and take that.
Coach Musk tweeted this last night about there's a lot of paths to the NBA or something along those lines, and you know Mason Jones' path to where he's at today has been a windy road already. Why would his path to the NBA be any different? So I would suspect that he's going to just outwork whatever it takes. He may it may be a year or two or three or he may have to play overseas, come back. He may have to go through, what we've known as the D League, now the G League. But he's got a great sounding board or a great person in Eric Musselman to kind of guide him or at least answer some questions, because he knows all of that by coaching international, coaching development leagues in the old D League, now G League. So there's a guy that can at least – kind of point him in some right directions, I would think.
And want to remind everyone, Eric Musselman will be joining us at 7:15 on his birthday, of all things. Got a call from Mike Kaywood, the basketball SID, yesterday and said Mus wants to come on his birthday. So that shows
he wanted
you,
to come on our show?
Yeah, I wanted to come on our birthday.
Does he have us confused with somebody?
I guess. So I don't know. Last quickie headline for you. Pepsi has unveiled its new apple pie flavored cola for the holidays. Will you be trying this?
Because
I love apple pie.
I love apple pie.
Do you like Pepsi, though?
I don't like Pepsi. Musk likes Pepsi.
We need to ask him about that.
But doesn't he like Diet Pepsi?
He's a Diet Pepsi man. But maybe he'll splurge for the holidays.
That's one of the few things that me and Musk can't agree on.
Diet Pepsi?
Diet Pepsi. Now, apple pie is supposed to be hot. Now, I can't think of – and cola is not supposed to be hot. So I can't think of anything worse than a –
have you never had cold apple pie?
Well, I have, but, I mean, apple pie hot is superior to cold apple pie.
Do you put cheese on your apple pie?
No, that's a northern thing.
I think my dad –
I put Cool Whip or ice cream.
Okay, that's probably the way to go. So my dad's not doing cheese anymore. He has one pizza a month, and that's it. That's the only cheese intake he's doing. But I feel like my dad did that every once in a while. Now, he's diabetic. So he's not a huge sweet fan, but every once in a while, I feel like when we'd go to a restaurant, he'd get cheese on his apple pie. That is something I've never done, and I love apple pie. But that's going to round out your quick hitting headlines. Want to dive into this next conversation about Ed Ogeron and kind of what he had to say about Greg Brooks, Joe Fouché, and that's coming up here on The Morning Rush.
All right, quick hitting headlines are brought to you by Kevin Hickey and his law partners. If you're building a home, that can be a stressful time, whether you're the homeowner or the contractor. If you got changes in plans, subcontractors not showing up, non-payment, any of these issues can cause homeowners or contractors to be at odds, and this can result in lawsuits. If you're the homeowner or the contractor and you find yourself needing legal help, call the attorneys at Kevin Hickey Law Partners. They have experience in representing homeowners and contractors. Brad Hull or Kevin Hickey are available to you to take your call at 479-434-2414 in the River Valley office, 479-802-6560 in the Northwest Arkansas office, or you can find those numbers and more about Kevin and Brad both online. New web address, so remember this one. It's easy to remember, artriallawyers.com. That's artriallawyers.com for the attorneys at the Kevin Hickey Law Partners.
Here was Ed Ogeron being asked, and I believe Tom Murphy asked them this question. Is either Tom or Bob, about some Louisiana kids. He mentioned Greg Brooks, mentioned Joe Fouché, and kind of what went on during their recruitment to LSU.
You know, here's what you want. Sure, yeah. I believe both of those young men came down camp, and we were very close to taking both of them. You know, you can't take everybody. but they were right there as very important prospects in the state of Louisiana. I'm glad to see both of those guys went well. I know the high school coach as well. I'm glad to see they're playing well. And yeah, when you're from Louisiana and you don't go to LSU and you play against LSU, you fire up the team and you want to have a good game, and I understand that.
You think about Greg Brooks, you think about Joe Fouché. Greg was the one that had that pick six in the Mississippi State game. Joe Fouché had two interceptions in the game this year as well. But there's a good chunk of Louisiana kids that have had program-impacting plays throughout their tenure at Arkansas. Anthony Lucas, Richard Smith, Tony Bua. Think about this year, Devion Warren, Joe Fouché, Devin Bush, some other guys in the past, Scooter Harris, Jericho Nelson. I mean, there's some guys that you can label and know immediately. Louisiana, we talk about Dallas, Texas. We talk about Tulsa. Louisiana, like the Shreveport area, not so much New Orleans and Baton Rouge, but Arkansas's had a good chunk of Louisiana kids that have helped impact their program for the better.
Well, and it's the old stat is more NFL draft picks per capita come out of the state of Louisiana than any other state. So, I mean, why would that, and it borders your state, why would you not be there? And I know there's other colleges and there's the Saints, but, I mean, LSU's the kingpin in that state. I mean, so, but why would you not want to slip down there and recruit that state? They can't sign them all.
They can't sign them
all. A&M's trying to get some, and LSU's going to go across that Texas line and try to get some right in your wheelhouse over in that northeast Texas corner. So, I mean, absolutely. I mean, particularly in northern Louisiana, that's been a great spot, not just for football, but, you know, ever heard of a guy named Scotty Thurman? He came out of a place called Ruston. So northern Louisiana, there's some kids that certainly, have some affection for the state of Arkansas there.
No question about it. It's about 5.5 hours from Fayetteville, just looking at my Google Maps right now. So it's not too far, but, I mean, you mentioned just most of those guys that I just listed off are from, like, the Shreveport area. And I just think that's kind of cool. And you think about you brought up basketball. I mean, you think about the one you almost had is Karl Malone. Like, that's another guy that you almost had as far as that is concerned. So this has been an area not only in football but basketball as well that Arkansas has taken advantage of.
Just think about this, you know, because we're sitting not very far from the interchange of what would be I-49 that would connect Fayetteville, and you mentioned Shreveport. Think about, you know, and we may never live to see it, and you're a lot younger than me, and we're both a lot younger than Ben, who's sitting across the showroom from us here at World of Wire. Think about if we ever get I-49 connected, what kind of pipeline that might could be where – Louisiana and that Shreveport area and even northeast Texas. That's what, hey, you want to come up with a reason to get I-49 built? Football recruiting. There's your reason. That just kind of connected in my head as we're talking about this, because then you'd have a four-lane road from Fayetteville to not only Louisiana, Shreveport, but also that northeast Texas area, Tyler and Lufkin and all that area down in there would be so much easier to access for kids to come to Fayetteville. So we got to get this bridge across river.
Is that an ASIN? Is that a Trump? Is that a Biden thing?
That's all of them.
All of them?
All
okay.
Of them.
I'll get them on
the
phone.
We got to get about $1 billion and get this road done. We got to get this bridge over here to help football recruiting.
Yeah, that should be the main rationale and reasoning behind that.
I mean, but think about it. I mean, it's 71 south, or you go through Oklahoma on 270 now, through Tallahena and that beautiful drive, but it's – you know, try driving from the River Valley to Texarkana right now, because that's how you got to go. It's 3 hours, and it's a lot of two-lane. You get a four-lane road similar to I-49 all the way down there, and I promise you the availability of kids that want to come to the University of Arkansas will open up, because mom and dad can come watch games, come visit. Kids can go home much faster, much easier. That area will open up when that highway opens up, whenever that is.
And you've talked about this with me a little bit with the Fayetteville. What's the Little Rock to Fayetteville? What's that before the trail? What is it now?
Well, I mean, there's 23 that goes from Ozark up there. That's the actual pick trail. But old 71, I think, is what you're actually talking
okay,
about.
Okay, so whatever was built to, as far as, like, get people up from the Central Arkansas area to – Fayetteville. Well,
I-49.
I-40. That's what I'm trying to. Right. I don't know streets. Okay. I'm 25. So, okay.
Believe it or not, Ty, there was a day that when you got to Alma, you didn't get on I-49. You got on Old 71.
Yeah, you've talked about how many more people congregate from the Central Arkansas, absolutely, Southern Arkansas, Eastern Arkansas area because of that road and how much less time it takes to get up. And it's not just for football purposes, for business purposes, and an array of reasons. That would be another thing that I think is just another example of that occurring and that happening. So,
I mentioned Louisiana and that Northeast Texas area. You just think about South Arkansas. You think about Texarkana. You think about Hope. You think about everything along that I-30 corridor, that there's no real good way to get south to north in this state, and kids to come, going south becomes just as attractive as coming north a lot of times.
Got a text in here from Zach in Ozark. He says, you can't hardly get to North Texas without getting a ticket in those small town speed traps. And my dad has preached to me since I was 16 to be very careful of congregating through small towns. Well, with that, if they ended up building that road, that wouldn't necessarily be a factor as far as that is concerned.
I'm just saying, one day, and I don't know, like I said, I don't know if I'll live long, and I'm 40, but be 45 next month. I don't know if I'll live long enough to see I-49 completed, but that's a hotbed for recruiting in northern Louisiana, northeast Texas. It'll just be easier for kids to get up there someday whenever that's built.
Push the agenda, Sam Pittman. That's what you got to do.
So. There's another reason for all of us as Arkansans. One more reason, in Tommy Kraft's opinion, to get that road built.
Before we go to David at South Arkansas, you mentioned new roads. We were driving to Panama City Beach one time when I was a couple years back, and we took this one road that it had on us on Google Maps, Tommy. It said new, and it was in Birmingham. It said new something.
Yeah.
We're like, okay, it just got built. Cool.
I-20 corridor.
Is that what it is?
Yep.
All right, so we're driving on it. All of a sudden, it starts getting rocky, and it's dark outside. My buddy Saban didn't have his lights on, and – luckily we stopped because at the end there was a cliff, like it was just a drop off. So we're lucky we stopped at that point and then just go escapading off to our death at that point.
You've been like Chevy Chase on Vacation.
Just been out in the desert. Luckily we had the wherewithal to turn around and decide, hey, this road is not complete.
You didn't see the barricades?
We didn't. No, there was no barricades. That's what was weird about that. It was odd. So 877-377-6963, the number to call or text in. Going to South Arkansas, welcoming in David, who's got a question on Arkansas recruiting. David, you're on the Morning Rush.
Well, good morning, gentlemen. I'm enjoying the conversation about LSU recruiting in South Arkansas. Listening to my dad, he tells me how Highway 167 was supposedly blacktop from El Dorado to Baton Rouge just so LSU could come up and recruit South Arkansas. And you think about how many players have gone from South Arkansas to LSU and Ole Miss through the years because, like you say, Fayetteville was like God near impossible to get to, it seemed like, from South Arkansas. But that's one of the reasons I hate LSU and Ole Miss as much as anybody, as well as Texas, of course. It's just growing up, and there's a lot of people in this area that go to LSU and Ole Miss, God knows why. But they've always recruited this area, always been a connection. Someday I'll get my dad to tell me more stories about it. There's money involved back in the 50s and 60s. I guarantee you that, people going to LSU and places. Anyway, wonderful, wonderful stories. Thanks, guys.
Appreciate it, David. I think of an example. Now, this isn't football or basketball, and I think his father went there. But Jaden Hill, who was a superb pitcher from Ashdown, elected to choose LSU over Arkansas. I mean, I can't exactly place Ashdown on a map.
It's down by Texarkana.
I know it. Yeah, I know it's southern Arkansas. Now it's southern.
It's north of Texarkana.
Yeah. So, when it comes to just that conversation, you hopefully will be able to get more of those southern Arkansas kids, and they choose the Razorbacks over LSU. But you mentioned the road part of that. As definitely any improvement on Arkansas roadways in the future will help football recruiting, as you mentioned, Tommy.
Yeah, we are live at World of Wireless this morning, celebrating 25 years. You get a Google Home Hub and a $100 Visa gift card when you make the move to Dish. Plus, they'll lock in your price for 2 years. If you got three TVs in your home, it's about $75 a month with a Hopper system when you sign up right now. Come by and see Ben this morning. He's got some great gifts for you if you want to stop in. Right at the light next door to Frank Row Furniture in Barling. We'd love to see you here this morning at World of Wireless.
COVID trends are going the wrong way. I want to talk about those Nets, what it's looking like for Arkansas in this upcoming game against the LSU Tigers. Hour number two on the way. Eric Musselman joins us at 7:15. Richard Davenport at 8 and then 8:05. And then we're going to have Tom Murphy at 7:45. Loaded show. Stay with us. It's the Morning Rush.
Make a hot spring spa part of your day-to-day routine and discover what it means to get more out of your day. Burton Pools and Spas is your local hot spring spa dealer. Hot Spring Spas, the number one spa brand, helps reduce stress, ease muscle pain, and helps you get a better night's sleep. Invest in your...
When you're looking for outdoor power equipment, head to R-Track, where we've got the area's best selection of tractors and mowers. Check out our side-by-side UTVs, Argo Amphibious XTVs, and Hammerhead Go-Karts. We rent professional quality equipment and service everything we sell. Stop by today. Get the R-Track advantage.
Off I-40 at exit 58 at 219 East Taylor Road in Clarksville. You can check out their inventory online at rtrack.com.
This is Pastor Heath from Woodland. I know some of these ads make you glad, but most probably make you mad. The reason is people believe the lie that heals is better than the truth that hurts. Our purpose at Woodland is to risk the hurt by exposing the lies so you can be wise unto salvation. If you'd like to know more, check out our website, woodlandpeople.church. There you can download our app and listen to our podcast. That's woodlandpeople.church.
Frank Row Furniture Super Black Friday Blowout Sale, 2 p.m. to 6 p.m. Thanksgiving Day, 8:30 a.m. to 6 p.m. Friday the 27th, and 6:30 to 5:30 p.m. Saturday the 28th. For example, Catnapper Reclining Sofa and Love, regular $22.50, on sale finance price $18.22, cash price $16.70. Store-wide sale, all furniture, bedroom furniture, and mattresses on sale. 3 days only at Frank Row Furniture Super Black Friday Sale. Best seats in the house.
Tommy Kraft here. When it came time for new gates and some fence repairs at my home, the Fence Man was my first call. The Fence Man does it all, from large commercial jobs to small residential repairs. Wood privacy fence, vinyl fence, commercial or residential chain link, even custom wrought iron fencing. 479-782-3936. 18 months, same as cash financing with approved credit, is now available. If it involves fencing, the Fence Man does it. The Fence Man. He ain't afraid of no work. 479-782-3936.
ESPN Arkansas and HitThatLine.com.
0% financing for 84 months on all 2020 Buicks, GMC Terrains, and GMC Acadias at Harry Robinson Buick GMC. Get 0 for 84 months on the hottest selling Buick model, the Buick Encore, or 0 for 84 on the Buick Enclave, loaded with luxury and third row seating. 0% financing for 84 months on all 2020 Buicks, GMC Terrains, and Acadias at Harry Robinson Buick GMC. Exit 11 off of I-540 in Fort Smith.
Frank Row Furniture Super Black Friday Blowout Sale, 2 p.m. to 6 p.m. Thanksgiving Day the 26th, 8:30 a.m. to 6 p.m. Friday the 27th, and 8:30 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. Saturday the 28th. For example, Catnapper Reclining Sofa and Love, regular $22.50, on sale finance price $18.22, cash price $16.70. Store-wide sale, all furniture, bedroom furniture, and mattresses are on sale. 3 days only at Frank Row Furniture Super Black Friday Sale. Best seats in the house.
In this moment, who has your back? Do you know the name of your insurance agent? Does your insurance agent know your name? Or would you call a 1-800 number that connects you with who? Another state? Another country? Get a local independent insurance agent with Auto Owners Insurance. Someone you can call when the bad stuff happens. In this moment, get an agent who will protect you in that moment. Call Kohler & Green Insurance in Fort Smith, 484-9888, or in Van Buren, 474-9888, and online at kohlergreen.com.
You could win a year of free internet from Wave Rural Connect. Here's how it works. If you sign up and are contracted between October 1st and December 31st, 2020, you have a chance to win 1 year of internet based on the internet speed you signed up for. That's it. So what are you waiting for? Call 1-833-4-WAVE-RC or go online waveruralconnect.com to get details and sign up. Arkansas Valley Electric and Wave Rural Connect, changing the communities we serve.
Always get more at Orr.
We always put the customer first at Orr Chevrolet in Fort Smith. Since 1924, the Orr family of dealerships has grown based on one simple principle. Give the customer more money for their trades and give them a lower price on their new vehicle. It's a simple concept, really, but one that very few dealers honor anymore. Hey, we know you paid a lot of money for your vehicle, and Orr Chevrolet wants to pay you the maximum amount for it today. Then we'll give you an awesome price on a new Chevrolet. But we're not done giving you more. Included with any new vehicle sold, Orr Chevy will also give you a lifetime powertrain warranty, 2 years of free maintenance, and free car washes for life. So come get a lower price and more money for your trade today at Orr Chevrolet on Auto Park Drive in Fort Smith and 24/7 at OrrChevyFS.com. Chevy, find new roads.
You always get more at Orr.
ESPN Arkansas weather.
Sunshine with us today. Our high this afternoon will be into the lower 70s tonight. Mainly clear to partly cloudy and overnight low near 50. Friday, we're back to partly to mostly sunny skies. Our high low 70s. Saturday, clouds with a chance of a few showers. Our high near 70. I'm Sally Russell with your forecast on ESPN Arkansas.
Former Razorback and Super Bowl champion Brett Good joins the Morning Rush every Wednesday at 7:20. Join us as we talk special teams, NFL, and what's going on with Razorback football.
You're listening to the Morning Rush live from the Busch Light Studios on ESPN 95.3 KERX Paris Fort Smith.
This hour of the Morning Rush is brought to you by Bud Light, brewed with the best barley, rice, water, and hops to be America's favorite light beer. Bud Light, please drink responsibly.
Here's what you want to tell me, Coach. Thank you for paving the way for line coaches to become head coaches. And he had told me that in the SEC meeting. We talked about a couple of things. He wanted to know how COVID was. I said, we're fine. He said, okay, man, we're going to be ready to play. And I congratulate him on what a great job he was doing.
Hey, this is Darren McFadden. You're listening to the Morning Rush.
Live from the Busch Light Studios.
Bush. You're causing a major disturbance on my time.
If I'm here and you're here, doesn't that make it our time?
On your favorite Arkansas sports talk station. Streaming live from
hitthatline.com.
There's a lot of lions, tigers, and bears, but they ain't but one Razorback. Number one.
This is the Morning Rush.
Borderline erotic.
With Ty Richardson.
Hi, Ty.
That's cool. I can dig.
And Tommy Kraft.
Do I look happy?
What's wrong?
Lloyd!
The Morning Rush starts right now.
We're going to talk to Eric Musselman in about 15 minutes, head basketball coach at the University of Arkansas, as two of his guys, Isaiah Joe, drafted 49th overall to the 76ers, and then Mason Jones signed a free agent deal with the Houston Rockets. I know he's excited about two of his former players. We'll also dive into what he's thinking about next week, less than a week out from Arkansas basketball. But coming up, we're going to touch on what Ed Ogeron had to say to Sam Pittman about COVID-related stuff heading into the LSU-Arkansas game this week. We're also going to talk with Richard Davenport coming up at 8:05 because it's a Recruiting Thursday, and it's brought to you by Breed and RV this morning. They are having their last sale of the year right now. Despite everything going on, they are still getting the new trailers weekly, and they are marked down as soon as they hit the lot. These are RVs that you know and trust, Forest River, Dutchman, Thor, Coachman, and so many more. Your new purchase at Breen RV, thanks to Ransom and his crew, comes with free maintenance for life. So stop on by and see him. The Breen RV Center in Van Buren, your friends in the RV business. So let's, again, hear what Ed Ogeron had to say about Arkansas and just Sam Pittman and his appreciation towards Coach O.
You know, here's what you want to tell me. Coach, thank you for paving the way for line coaches to become head coaches. And he had told me that in the SEC meeting. We talked about a couple of things. He wanted to know how COVID was. I said, we're fine. He said, okay, man, we're going to be ready to play. And I congratulated him on what a great job he was doing. That's about the extent of the conversation.
So you made a point earlier this week, which I think is pretty valid. I mean, I can't 100% confirm this, but with Vegas, the line shifting. Started Arkansas was 3-point favorites. Now it's shifted to LSU being favored by 2.5 over the Razorbacks. You made the point that you don't think it's necessarily money-related, but you think it's more COVID-related.
Well, I've always read or been told that, you know, it takes like $1 million to move a line half a point in Vegas. So, I mean, I don't think there's been like $10 million or whatever bet on, you know, because the lines move, what, 5 points total? It started out at 3, now it's 2 the other way. I don't think there's collectively $10 million at this point early in the week bet on this game. So I think information's changed it. I pointed out to you a day or so ago about the Virginia Tech-Miami game. People were scratching their head a little bit looking at that line because Tech, an unranked team, was favored over a top-10 team in Miami. Yeah, the game was in Blacksburg, but, you know, some things didn't add up as far as why would that be. Well, Miami was missing players, barely had enough to play the game. They ended up winning the game by 1. But Vegas, and they're resourceful. They know what they're talking about. Miami was missing players, and Vegas knew it, and they had the line set appropriately.
You go back to last week, the LSU Tigers couldn't even scrimmage. They're getting an offensive lineman back from suspension. They now have 2 quarterbacks that can practice, both Johnson and Finley, after Zach Von Rosenberg, their punter, was having to play second-team quarterback last week. So that now begs the question to you, 877-377-6963. Has your opinion changed about the game on Saturday in terms of who you think is going to win?
I always, you know, a lot of fans talk themselves up, you know, a game you're an underdog. Well, I think we can win this game by Saturday, you know. I sometimes find myself worrying about details, and this year more than ever, because you don't know who you're going to be missing. And, I'm concerned about this game because LSU is number one coming off COVID, and they've had, you know, 3 weeks to get ready for a game. Now they've spent probably a week and a half getting ready for this game, but also think about this: any bumps, any bruises, any rehab done on players, they're going to be as healthy and fresh as they've ever been for a game. Now the counter to that is there rust, is there timing issues, is there pre-snap penalties, is there, you know, all those, because how much physicality are you willing to have in practice, even if you're LSU? So you know, Arkansas needs to get out to a quick, fast start. I think the counter for LSU this week is how much distraction with the USA Today story has that created for Ed Orgeron around this program and their preparation for this week. I'm hoping a bunch.
And, yeah, that's something that we mentioned on Tuesday, but we didn't talk about it much at all Wednesday. And I'm wondering when it – and I hesitate, and I get where you come from. It's so weird calling that a distraction based on what's going on.
I'm talking a distraction for Orgeron.
Yeah,
getting ready for a game.
And I get that, but it's just like from the severity of the report and what
right.
was inside that.
I'm not making light of what's going on. I'm just saying if your job is to get ready for a football game, Ed Orgeron has this major if you can find me a better word, I'll use it.
There's not one.
But he is distracted by this report in getting ready for a football game.
And – I mean, again, this is not the same LSU team. We've talked about many times how this is not the same Arkansas team. That's been evident by the 3 SEC wins that they've already picked up this season. Well, LSU is riding a lot of their accolades from last year. People done that. And Bo Pelini, you got a new defensive coordinator that was torched in game 1. Now, they do get after the quarterback. They've had some sacks this season. But I mentioned this earlier this week, 123rd out of 126 in passing defense. That's the second worst in the Power 5. They're going to be matched up man in a lot of these situations. Stingley Jr., my guess, would be on Treylon Burks the majority of this football game. And I know they have another good quarterback who's been playing well, and I'm forgetting his name. But you got, if you're Mike Woods and you're Trey Knox and you're Tyson Morris and some of the other wide receivers, you got to get open in these lockdown man coverages like Mississippi State was over to. So, because there's going to be people gunning for Felipe Franks, you got to give open and give him an opportunity to throw you the football.
Terrible time to be without Devian Warren, and but a great opportunity for, you mentioned some guys like a Tyson Morris or one of these guys that haven't factored in to really step up, or maybe a Trey Knox to finally show out. I don't know how it's going to be, but You're exactly right. Do they bracket Burks? What do they do to maybe limit his involvement? Woods obviously was the guy that came to play and has two catches, but they both counted for a lot last week. What happens? Or is Arkansas able to just line up and run the ball? That's what you'd like to see, is just take over the game. Due to LSU, what Florida did to Arkansas, just control the clock.
Three straight games with 200 or more rushing yards, and I think that Kendall Briles and Sam Pittman would love to see the exact same thing on Saturday, where you don't even have to force Felipe into a bunch of passing situations. You can line up with Traylon Smith or Rakeem Boyd and pound the football in LSU, control the clock even with up-tempo style, and really just beat him that way. That would be the ideal consideration if you're Kendall Briles and Sam Pittman facing the Tigers.
Yeah, I mean, you would love to just have some of these 12, 13, 14 play, 75-yard drives that suck 8-9 minutes off the clock. I mean, that's the ideal way. Now,
have they had one of those drives this day? They've had even their long ones, like 75 yards. It's been like in 5 minutes because of how fast they're going. Like that's what's like when we say control.
I don't
the clock,
have a box scores with me because they're over at the studio, but you're right. There haven't been plentiful, but they've had a few of those.
They need to
control the clock this week. They need to be versatile in that way. Hey, great conversation yesterday with Brett Goode. He joined us here, and he does every Wednesday. He's part of the winning team at Henderson Phillips Employer Solutions. He can help you tackle all of your employee benefit, health insurance, and staffing management solutions, plus any commercial or even personal insurance needs. So anything with insurance, employee benefits, retirement plans, he does all of those things. Text or call him, 479-651-2292. He'll come visit with you about all of those needs that you have. Northwest Arkansas, River Valley, anywhere you're listening, 651-2292, 479-651-2292 for Brett Goode with Henderson Phillips Employer Solutions.
Coming up, your head basketball coach Eric Musselman joins us on the Morning Rush. It's his birthday of all days, and he still wants to come on and talk Razorback basketball with you. He's next on the Morning Rush.
This is Recruiting Thursday on the Morning Rush, brought to you by Breeden RV, where your adventures begin.
Yes, sir!
If you have experience transporting frozen and refrigerated goods and want to be part of a trucking family with insurance and be home every week, you need to contact Brent Higgins Trucking. Since 1997, Brent Higgins Trucking in Mulberry has been proudly delivering to and from various areas of the United States, including but not limited to Oklahoma, Texas, Louisiana, and Mississippi. Brent Higgins Trucking, where you're a name, not a number. Contact them at 479-997-2366 or at BrentHigginsTrucking.com.
This is Randy Magnus, mortgage loan manager with RVS Bank in Fort Smith. Have you checked your mortgage rate lately? A lot of times people forget about their rate after their loan is closed. Your friends at RVS Bank would love the opportunity to review your current loan. With RVS competitive rates, you might be able to lower your monthly payment, shorten the term of your loan, or both. RVS services 99% of the loans that originate, so most of the time you can deal with any of our local branches for all your mortgage needs. Please give us a call at 479-573-1127 or download the Home For Me app to your mobile device and search for a Fort Smith loan officer. RVS Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Come see what's new at the Golf Nut, 5121 Towson Avenue in Fort Smith. In stock now, irons from TaylorMade, Mizuno, along with new woods and irons from Callaway. Also in stock, the RTX Zip Core Wedges and Spider Putters. The Golf Nut carries a great line of shoes, apparel, and accessories for your everyday golfing needs. As always, check Facebook for our daily specials. Work on your game in our indoor simulation base, or play a round of golf on great courses like Pebble Beach or Bethpage Black. The Golf Nut, Fort Smith's number one golf shop since 1994.
In the mood for a top-shelf night? 906 Cocktail and Cigar Lounge has your number. Sit back, relax, and enjoy select wines, top-shelf spirits, and handcrafted cocktails in a rich, comfortable, sanitized setting with state-of-the-art air filtration. Indulge in one of their delicious appetizers, sandwiches, salads, or specialty items for carryout or dine-in. Open Tuesday through Saturday. Stop by 906 Garrison Avenue in Fort Smith. 906 Garrison in Fort Smith. 906 Cocktail and Cigar Lounge. Defining nightlife in downtown Fort Smith.
Are your real estate investments being properly managed? Are you sending a check or cashing a check each month? If you're tired of your current property managers, then call Trinity Multifamily. Trinity will qualify your tenants and leases, inspect your properties, and take care of maintenance and provide you with web-based access to current financial reports, leases, and pictures of your property. Call Trinity Multifamily at 479-452-1817 or online at trinitymultifamily.com. Trinity Multifamily, your teammate in the real estate game.
Randall Ford is excited
excited to announce their state-of-the-art mobile service van, stocked with all the latest tools and technology needed to service your vehicle. Everything from oil changes, warranty repair, battery, software updates, brake jobs, and so much more. All is done with your convenience and safety in mind. We'll come to your office or home to provide professional service the Randall Ford way. Stop by today at Randall Ford, 5500 Rogers Avenue, or check us out online 24/7, randallford.com. Ford, the number one selling brand in America.
Do you have sleep apnea? Are you tired of dealing with a CPAP every night? The noise, the constant cleaning, your wife telling you she can't take the noise anymore. Dr. Bo Sparkman at Family Dental Care of Fort Smith can help you with sleep apnea with a custom dental appliance that allows you to get rid of that annoying CPAP. Dr. Sparkman has years of experience and has treated hundreds of patients just like you. Call for your appointment today, 785-1419. That's 785-1419. Get rid of your CPAP with Family Dental Care of Fort Smith.
Oh my gourd, folks. Larry Rath here from Rath Auto Resources. This month, I want to say thanks. So I'm on a mission to make car buying easy as pie and help you snag a sweet deal on one of our Rath Road Ready vehicles, each one hand-picked and inspected in our Meineke Car Care Center. This month, you could drive a nicer, newer car and save up to $4,150. That's a lot of dough. So if your old ride is flaky, crusty, burnt, or rusty, don't let it squash your happiness. Trade it for a nicer, newer car now, even if you still owe money, and save up to $4,150. Plus, my For the People approval process makes financing your nicer, newer car easy as pie. Keeping the car you have? Get it ready for winter in our Meineke Car Care Center with half-off brakes and buy three, get one free on all tires. Deals this delicious won't last long, so visit us today at Arkansas's favorite used car dealer, Rath Auto Resources and the Meineke Car Care Center, 4515 Towson Avenue, Fort Smith, or online, rathauto.com.
ESPN 95.3.
It's not just being in Northwest Arkansas. It's not just coaching in Fayetteville. It's a statewide thing, and it's unlike anything that I've ever experienced. The one thing that is just so unique is anywhere you go in the state of Arkansas, that hog, the logo, the brand is so, so powerful. And basketball-wise, the passion for that hog logo is just so powerful and so much different than anywhere that I've ever experienced.
This is Coach Mugg, and you're listening to The Morning Rush.
Back here on The Morning Rush, we're going to be joined by head basketball coach at the University of Arkansas, Eric Musselman, shortly get his take on one of his guys getting drafted 49th overall to the Philadelphia 76ers. That would be Isaiah Joe. And then Mason Jones signing a free agent deal with the Houston Rockets.
Yeah, looking forward to that conversation coming up in just a few moments. We're brought to you by Burton Pools and Spas. Make a hot spring spa part of your day-to-day routine and discover what it means to get more out of every day with Burton Pools and Spas, your local hot spring spa dealer. 28 models to choose from, including several that are saltwater models. So you can choose that. You can ease muscle pain, reduce stress, just feel better every day with a hot spring spa from Burton Pools and Spas. They're in Springdale. They're also in Fort Smith, and you can view all the models online at burtonpools.com. Burton Pools and Spas, they are your source for backyard fun.
And let's go right to Coach this morning. Coach, we will get into Mason and Isaiah's big announcement last night, but first and foremost, want to wish you a happy birthday. Riley and Mike let me know that yesterday. Of all things to do on your birthday, joining the Sports Talk Radio Show, man.
It's great to come on with you guys. Appreciate you having me on, Ty and Tommy. And, we don't need to talk about my birthday because as you get older, you know that's the last thing you want to know about.
All right, so if you don't want to talk about your birthday, let's talk.
Happy birthday anyway,
yeah,
boss.
Let's talk about last night, Coach. And it was really cool to see not only Isaiah's reaction, Mason's reaction, but I know we got to see your reaction, Danielle's reaction, Michael's reaction, and just the excitement that you guys had. What are the Philadelphia 76ers getting in Isaiah Joe?
Well, you know, they're getting a young player who's got a lot of upside. You know, the NBA game is about shooting and scoring. You know, but as all second rounders, and you know, I talked to Mason late last night, and you know, I told him, like, and this is true whether you're drafted or not, like, now the real work begins. It's hard. I mean, I've been a part of that league where second rounders get cut in training camp. I've been a part of the league where I had to beg the Golden State Warriors to bring Brian Cardinal to camp as our 19th man, and he ended up making the team and starting. So there's a, you know, there's a lot of twists and turns and different stories that happened from this moment on. Certainly for Isaiah to get drafted is, you know, a really, really special, you know, thing. I mean, just there's only 60 of them. It's really, really hard to get drafted. You know, it's interesting. I mean, last year at the draft, Cody Martin got drafted. You know, he played for us at Nevada. His twin brother, Caleb, did not get drafted. And they both ended up making Charlotte's team. And the last NBA game that Charlotte's played, I think the non-drafted player went 5 of 6 from 3 in an NBA game. So, you know, Mason's story has not ended. Isaiah's story has not ended. I think both those guys have the talent to play in the league. But it's going to be up to them to be ready for training camp. And more than likely, both will spend time in the G League. I'm quite certain that will be the case with both guys, that, you know, that the G League is going to be part of what they go through this upcoming year. Now, what happens with the G League, we don't even know right now. You know, there has been talk that, that maybe there won't be a G League this year. So how it all plays out, you know, will be really, really interesting. But being drafted, I can tell you it's really, really special for these guys. And it's really good for us from a recruiting standpoint. You know, all high school players aspire to play at the next level. And when your program, you know, can have guys that get drafted. I mean, I was really happy for Jalen Harris, who played for us at Nevada. He was a transfer from Louisiana Tech, and he got drafted late by Toronto. And I was happy for him too. So it's a great day for guys. But like I said, I mean, in reality, we've never had a draft, and then basically a couple weeks later, you're right into training camp, and that's what's going to happen. I mean, there's not much time to celebrate. Because this training camp is going to come upon these guys really, really quickly.
Coach, I love how you brought up Brian Cardinal, the custodian who played a pivotal part in the 2011 finals as a Dallas Maverick. But we were talking about Mason earlier, and this just kind of plays into his psyche, right? He's the SEC co-player of the year, averaged 22 points a game, and still doesn't get drafted. And to me, I mean, going from Finley Prep to Connor State to Arkansas, continuously getting better, improving his body. I mean, Coach, doesn't this seem like it's the perfect scenario for Mason? Oh, you're going to keep proving me wrong? Okay, watch what I can do here.
Yeah, I mean, he was disappointed last night, but he wasn't, you know, he wasn't crushed. I mean, you could hear in his voice that he, you know, that this was not going to, you know, this was not going to take him down. That he was still determined. You know, so yeah, I think like with Mason, it's and in reality, I'm telling you guys, like once you hit training camp, because the money of a first rounder is so significant that they're not cutting those guys, or they're not sending first rounders to the G League for extended time for the most part. So second round, non-drafted, guys on two ways, like Mason's going to sign, like all those, they're kind of all thrown together once you get to camp. And in a normal year, it's how do you produce at the Las Vegas Summer League? And then how do you produce in training camp? And then once you go to the G League, how do you produce? And then you form your role in the NBA. That's just how it is for guys that are, you know, on rosters that are 10, 11, 12, 13 men on NBA rosters. And then for the two-way guys, the guys that are 15, 16 on those rosters, that's kind of the path that you have to take. So from this moment on, it's about productivity. It's about how hard you practice. Because for the most part, you know, you're going to have to earn your stripes. And so it's so fascinating to watch. But if you walk into almost every SEC locker room right now, men's basketball locker room, and you said, how many of you guys think you're going to play in the NBA? Almost every hand would go up. And you talk about Mason Jones being co-player of the year in the SEC, non-drafted. You talk about Reggie Perry. I think he was 57th pick. He was co-SEC player with Mason, and he was three picks away from not being drafted. So I think it's also, you know, you've got to look at this thing in its totality. It also lets players know how difficult it truly is to hear your name called on draft night. And think about how hard it is to be drafted in the first round. But our league was really, really represented incredibly well in that first round.
Yeah, I mean, I put something on Twitter, and I watched, and I was kind of dipping it out, but four of the first 14 picks, as I'm sure you noted, were from the SEC, and none of them were from Kentucky. And to me, that was the notable part. Yes, the four of the 14, but you'd expect two of those. Surely two of them were from Kentucky, right? No, they weren't. And that tells you about the depth of this league, and I think with coaches like you and others that have joined this league, the league's improved and gotten deeper. Now, Kentucky caught up and got on the board, and then this league ends up with 12 leading all the other leagues. But, Coach, that tells you how good this league has become, not in just totality with the 12 picks, but four of the first 14, and they're not three of the four being Kentucky this time.
There's no doubt, and you know, like as the draft's going on, you got to think about Vanderbilt, right?
Yeah.
I mean, gets drafted, and Saban Lee gets drafted, and a year before, Garland goes early in the first round. So you're talking about Vanderbilt, the team that struggled, and I get that Naismith and Garland were injured, but it shows you the level that you have to recruit in this league, because as these names were popping up, we're sitting there saying, like, you know, we got to keep getting better. We've got to keep increasing our talent when you're seeing all these first rounders. And again, no question, like, we were really, really excited for Isaiah, but from an internal standpoint, because I was watching it with several of our staff members, and we had a text thread going because we wanted to make sure that we didn't have too many people over at our house because of COVID. We wanted to, now that we're a week away, trying to do everything we can to keep everybody happy. But we were texting each other, and you know, like in this league, you know, first rounders, I mean, that's who you're playing against, and ultimately, you know, you've got to win with the same level of talent or more to beat people. And so we got a lot of work to do as well.
Yeah. Anything else on the draft? I mean, I want to talk about your team now because, you know, there's so many questions we got about that. But anything else you want to talk about on the draft? Because I'm sure you could talk about that for another half hour with us.
No, I mean, I had the staff rolling last night. We were going through draft stories early in the first round, kind of waiting, you know, because we knew that our guys were basically, you know, 45 above the feedback that we had gotten, especially the day before the draft. So we kind of knew, you know, that we had some time where we could just kind of casually sit back. And some of the stories I was telling about the draft room, and we probably don't have time today unless you want me to go into a lot of different segments, which I'm sure you don't. Well, but when you're in a draft room, when you're in a draft room with Jerry West, just crazy stuff that people would have no idea. And then, you know, the trade calls that are coming and going, and just a lot of funny stories. But, you know, people always talk about a player getting a promise. I was with the team. I won't say who. We had one draft pick, and unfortunately, management had told 12 different players that they had promises. So we had one pick. And so, you know, those are some of the things that I try to educate our players on, because I've been in those draft rooms, and I try to tell people all the time, you know, all these coaches at the collegiate level can talk about the draft and the process. If you haven't been in the draft room, you only know it from one lens. And it's, it gets wild in the draft room. I can promise you that. I've also been a part of the San Diego Padres. I sat in on two drafts with Kevin Towers, who at that point was the GM, and I've seen what happens in a baseball draft. And I hope at one point to be in the draft room in the NFL, because to me it's so fascinating what goes on in these rooms and the pressure and who's really prepared and which scouts really, really can stand up with a bold, in a forceful opinion on a player, and which guys are weak and waffling back and forth between the guys on their evaluation. So it's really a fascinating process.
Well, Coach, we're less than a week away from the season's scheduled start, and I want to get into, you mentioned COVID. We're seeing, you know, a rise in the numbers. We're seeing football games in our conference right now being postponed, and teams not having enough players. I wanted to kind of talk to you and kind of get a peek behind the curtain and how it's going to work in basketball, because we know in football, if you don't have the required numbers to play, they postpone the game. How is that going to work in your sport with contact tracing, with positive numbers? You have a much smaller roster, obviously, than football. How is that going to work in your sport with 15 players, 13 scholarship players, smaller staffs, when COVID issues arise?
I don't think we really know. And this is only my opinion. And I wish we would have started on time. You know, I wish we would have already been 2 weeks into this thing, and we already would have had three or four games under my belt. Again, that's only, you know, my opinion. Because, I mean, obviously, you know, if you study, if you read, you know, the COVID numbers continue to rise, throughout the country. And so it's a huge concern. I know, for myself, I have not had it. I've tried to do everything, that I possibly can not to get it. However, having said that, last night, I think probably four times during the draft, I asked Danielle to take my temperature because I felt like I was getting the chills. Well, temperature is normal. Like all of us, anything that happens, you think you might have it, which is, scary. And I want to coach because that's my job. But you look at all the coaches that have got it in all different sports, and now all of a sudden you're starting to see more college basketball coaches getting it because you're with your team, which is college-age students, and it just happens no matter how much you wear a mask. And for our particular team, we have had a good portion of players and staff have it. And just based on what they're telling you from a medical standpoint, we cannot get a mask hit with the thing just because we've already majority of our parties already had it. But there will probably be games canceled for sure. You're going to have to adjust on the fly. You're going to have to be flexible on the fly.
So let me clarify what you said. There's a majority of your team that has had it at this point. Is that what you said?
Yeah. Yep.
Okay. Because at that point, your players don't have to retest for 90 days after they're positive, correct?
Yeah. So I'm not sure the exact day, but it's one day I hear it's 90, one day it's 120 days. But yes, for the majority of our guys, from a testing standpoint, and then from, medically, can you get it? We have a window where a good portion of our guys have had COVID and, are not at risk of at least from what we know, of getting COVID again. We still have a couple guys that, along with myself and a very few number of staff members that have not had it.
Eric Musselman with us here on the Morning Rush. So, Coach, kind of to go off that question, let's say the worst happens, and I know Kermit, you mentioned SEC coaches had it. Kermit Davis, it was announced that he tested positive. Let's say you do get it. We knew Barry Odom was going to be the interim head coach if Sam Pittman got it. Well, that's what happened. I'm assuming that if something was to happen on the basketball side of things, would David Patrick be the interim head coach for the time being?
Yeah, he would. The one thing – yes, Coach Patrick would for sure. I know he'd do a great job. Obviously, did a great job at UC Riverside as as the head coach there. That part of the, you know, but we have a staff that, you know, Corey Williams has been a head coach at Stetson, Division I school in Florida. Clay Mosier has been a head coach in the minor leagues overseas. So we have three guys that you know, that have great experience. But Coach Patrick would be the guy that would call the timeouts, have final say on substitutions. And, you know, the one thing is, whether it's Coach Pittman or whether it's, you know, Kermit Davis at Ole Miss, or we've gotten to this point as of today, basically everything that we're going to do is in. You know, you hope that through months and months and months of preparation that your ball club can semi-function on its own, with in-game decisions obviously being really important and substitutions being really important. But, you know, from a, you know, what are we doing offensively, the technique, the fundamentals, the exact footwork, the spacing on offense, all those little details have already been implemented. It's interesting because right now we're scheduled to practice today, Friday, and Saturday. And Saturday, you know, we can't wait for the football game. So we would go before the 11 o'clock tip, which means a really, or the 11 a.m. Kickoff. So that would mean we'd have to tip off practice early in the morning. I'm trying to figure out, how do we get the guys to the finish line, meaning next Wednesday, where we're fresh mentally, fresh physically. And we're right at that point right now where our guys are getting burned out because we haven't played a game in so long, and it's been so much practice. And so I'm even trying to figure out, as we're less than a week away, like, what does this last week look like? And so I'm going back to some of the things that we've done with NBA teams way back when you were allowed to have true two-a-days in the NBA, and how we kept guys fresh leading up to that first game, the last week of the season. So I'm going to pull out some of those old practice plans today, and we're going to probably alter practice a little bit. The next 3 days, 4 days will be a little bit different than they have been.
Are you going to allow yourself any fun today on your birthday, or is it all work, all business today?
No,
do something fun.
Look, we're going to go to we're going to have dinner with a small group of guys on staff, and Danielle and Ryan, my son Michael. We will have fun. We have way more fun than people know.
Are you going to, like, eat something fun, or is it going to be like low carb, like all healthy? I mean, are you going to eat something fun too?
Danielle's got a whole bunch of cookies right here. She surprised me with the cookies. They say Must Bus on them. And we got some Woo Pig Suey ones, and we got some hog cookies, and she's going to bring them to the end of practice today. And then I'm sure she's got a cake hidden around here somewhere.
There you go.
But yes, we will. I'll probably have a salad because we're too close to tip off. And, you know, you gotta try to look as good as you possibly can in the polo. And so it'll probably be salad and a little bit of birthday cake, and that's it.
Well, semi-fun then. All right, well, happy birthday. And, hey, thanks for carving out some time for us today on your birthday.
No, you guys, thanks so much for having me on. Ty, Tommy, appreciate it. Good luck with the rest of your show today.
All right, we got about 25 more questions if you want to come back next week. So.
All right, you guys, thanks so much.
All right, happy birthday.
Good stuff from Eric Musselman this morning, getting good feedback from Isaiah and Mason last night, and then talking a little basketball leading up to next Wednesday as far as that is concerned. So really excited about this basketball team as just as we do that.
Yeah.
So
the big nugget he dropped there, most of the teams had it at this point. I don't think as far as COVID, I thought that was the big knowledge bomb he dropped there, was kind of where his team stands with COVID.
Yep. It is a recruiting Thursday, and it's brought to you by Breeden RV in Van Buren. Despite everything going on, they're still getting new trailers weekly, and they're marked down as soon as they hit the lot. These are RV brands that you know and that you trust. Forest River, Dutchman, Thor, Coachman, and so many more. Plus, your new purchase comes with free maintenance for life. You're not going to find that anywhere else. Ransom and his crew have the best customer service and the best deals around. So come by and see him at the Breeden RV Center in Van Buren, your friends in the RV business. business.
Of course, that conversation is going to be in our Bud Light Seltzer Morning Rush podcast. You can relive that. We'll have that up soon. A lot of good stuff in there. A lot of good conversation there to retake with Musk. A lot of good stuff on the draft from last night.
Yeah, he is an encyclopedia of knowledge. I love how he brought up Brian Cardinal for all you Dallas Mavericks fans out there, who was a big part of that 2011 championship team that defeated Dwayne Wade, LeBron James, Chris Bosh, and the Miami Heat. So he is just, again, when it comes to basketball, historia, there's no one better than Eric Musselman.
All right, we'll recap that some more and get some more reaction on that conversation with Eric Musselman on the other side of the break. We're brought to you by Gaston's White River Resort. 870-431-5202 is their number. Start a new Thanksgiving tradition at Gaston's White River Resort. You can head there for Thanksgiving. They have an all-day buffet at Gaston's White River Resort from 10 to 7. It's reservation only this year, but they'll have ham, turkey, and New York strip on the buffet this year. All the sides that are your favorites, all the desserts there as well. So get over to Gaston's this year and enjoy a new tradition with your family. You can stay for the weekend as well. Call and make a reservation. Have 80 private cabins and lodges for you to socially distance just with your family. That's Gaston's White River Resort, 870-431-5202. Gaston's White River Resort, a first-class time. Every time.
We're trying to outwork everybody in recruiting.
This is Recruiting Thursday on the Morning Rush, brought to you by Breeden RV, where your adventures begin.
At any of the Clay Maxey companies, it's just an easy, customer-centered experience. We wanted to make it a one-stop shop, so we added Kawasaki and Can-Am and Hustler and Worldline. It's really been a nice add for us. We provide full service. We're doing pickup and delivery. We were able to add the Vexus line, which is a premier bass boat line. We want to make it easy. We want you to visit us at any of the Clay Maxey companies, Clay Maxey Ford and Harrison, Berryville Motorsports, Marine, or Clay Maxey NWA.
Standard Materials Group has immediate openings for ready-mix drivers in the Northwest Arkansas area. If you have a CDL license without an automatic restriction and want to be home every night, want to work with a company that offers great pay, benefits, and a great team environment with growth opportunities, apply today at jobs.crh.com. Again, that's jobs.crh.com. Standard Materials Group is an equal opportunity employer.
This is Brett Goode, former Razorback and Super Bowl champion with the Green Bay Packers. Everyone loves to be on a winning team. That is why I have joined Henderson Phillips Employer Solutions. Henderson Phillips can help you tackle all your employee benefit, health insurance, and staffing management solutions. Plus, I can help you with any commercial or personal insurance need. Come join my team at Henderson Phillips. Call me, Brett Goode, at 479-651-2292. That's 651-2292.
You can be the hero of the office. Just go to hitthatline.com and enter to win the Hardee's Lunch Bunch Contest. Every week, one lucky listener wins lunch from your local Hardee's restaurant for up to 15 people at your job site or workplace. It's easy to sign up. Just click on the Hardee's Lunch Bunch Contest button. Give us your information, and you're entered just like that. Every Thursday, we announce a winner during halftime. Win free lunch for all your work buddies. The Hardee's Lunch Bunch from Hardee's, ESPN Arkansas, and hitthatline.com.
0% financing for 84 months on all 2020 Buicks, GMC Terrains, and GMC Acadias at Harry Robinson Buick GMC. Get 0 for 84 months on the hottest selling Buick model, the Buick Encore, or 0 for 84 on the Buick Enclave, loaded with luxury and third row seating. 0% financing for 84 months on all 2020 Buicks, GMC Terrains, and Acadias at Harry Robinson Buick GMC. Exit 11 off of I-540 in Fort Smith.
If I'm taking time to shop, I want real selection. That's why I shop at Sody's. Sody's has the largest craft and import beer selection in the area. And the Pick 6 is always a favorite. Experience different at Sody's Wine & Spirits off I-540 on Phoenix Avenue.
Every day is worth celebrating at Uncorked. Cocktails, wine, craft beer, bourbons, and unbelievably great food. Uncorked on Phoenix Avenue next to Sody's.
Fitness will always be about keeping a routine. And the best routines in life will always make time for enjoying yourself. Michelob Ultra, superior light beer. Enjoy responsibly. AB Michelob Ultra Light Beer, St. Louis, Missouri.
New Bud Light Seltzer?
Yep.
A hard seltzer with a hint of fruit flavor?
Yep.
Can I try one?
Yep.
That tastes great.
Told ya.
Bud Light Seltzer, unquestionably good.
Anheuser-Busch Bud Light Seltzer. IRC Beers, beer in Texas. St. Louis, Missouri.
Have your travel plans changed? Looking for a place that's close to home and keep your family safe? Gaston's White River Resort is located on the beautiful White River. They offer private accommodations in their lodges and cabins. Most cabins have a fully equipped kitchen, or let their restaurant staff deliver to your cabin. Call 870-431-5202 and change your plans to Gaston's White River Resort. Gaston's White River Resort, a first-class time. Every time.
Did you know that you can get your car serviced or repaired without ever leaving your house? All you have to do is call Jody's Auto Service Center at 479-649-3399. Jody's will pick up your vehicle, service or repair it for you, and return it fully disinfected to your driveway. Pickup and delivery is free for jobs $75 or more. Jobs less than $75 can be picked up and returned for a $10 fee. Let Jody's Auto Service Centers handle all your service and vehicle repair needs. Call 479-649-3399. Jody's Auto Service Center.
Deer hunters, it's prime time, and the Deer Woods are the place to be. Jelco Outdoors has all the supplies and gear to make your hunt one to remember. Men's, women's, and children's boots and clothing to keep you warm and dry. Tree stands, scents, calls, safety vests, firearms, archery. Jelco has it all for you. Best of luck to all hunters. Stay safe, and remember, a great hunt begins at Jelco Outdoors, 4600 South Zero in Fort Smith.
Do you like paying rent or mortgage every month? Of course not. Thanks to real estate agents Nick and Ellie Gladwell and Chambers Bank, we're giving away free rent or mortgage payments for a year, up to $15,000. Now that's a good start to 2021. Go to hitthatline.com and enter the free rent or mortgage for a year sweepstakes now through December 14th. Complete contest rules are at hitthatline.com. Let us pay your rent or mortgage for a year, courtesy of Chambers Bank, real estate agents Nick and Ellie Gladwell, and ESPN Arkansas.
ESPN 95.3.
Good morning to the Morning Rush, everybody.
Y'all better put him in the Heisman. You better put him up there. I'm tired of him being number four.
We got that wood right here, baby.
Somebody better look at this guy. He's the best football player in the country, and his name's not being mentioned. Lou Holtz, Mark May. Number five, you better look at him a little closer. He's a football player.
Streaming live at hitthatline.com.
Welcome back into the Morning Rush on a Recruiting Thursday, brought to you by Breeden RV. In the next conversation, I want to dive into this Bear Bryant Coach of the Year watch list. Sam Pittman did not make it, but you'd be surprised to see some of the names on this list. And this is a conversation we will get into next on the Morning Rush.
We are live at World of Wireless, right at the light next door to Frank Rowe Furniture in Barling, celebrating their 25 years in business. We'll talk to Ben in the next hour, but be sure and check him out here at World of Wireless. We're brought to you by Arvest Bank. If you haven't checked your mortgage rate lately, a lot of times people forget about their rate after their loan is closed. Your friends at Arvest Bank would love to have the opportunity to sit down with you and review your loan. You can give them a call. Arvest services 99% of the loans that they originate. Right now, with their low interest rates, you can lower your monthly payment, shorten the term of your loan, or maybe do both. Call our friend Randy at 479-573-1127. That's 479-573-1127. He'll get the process started and tell you whether or not they can save you some money. You can also download the Home for Me app to your mobile device and search for an Arvest loan officer near you. Arvest Bank, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
So this Bryant Coach of the Year watch list includes some names that I think are very deserving to be on there and some not so deserving. Starting with Tom Allen, who is the head coach of Indiana. They have a big-time matchup this weekend against the Ohio State Buckeyes. Deserves to be on the list. Matt Campbell of Iowa State deserves to be on the list. Jamie Chadwell of Coastal Carolina also deserves to be on the list. And there's a couple more guys on here that are deserving as well. But then there's some interesting names that I question a little bit when I saw that. Clay Helton out at USC. I know they've won two close games to this point, but they've only played, what, two or three games? Tom Herman at Texas, for some reason, is on this watch list. Gus Malzahn of Auburn is on this watch list. I mean, those are three names. Lincoln Riley, Oklahoma's on this watch list, even though they have underperformed so far this season. Those are three or four names to me that makes no sense. Actually, it does make a lot of sense. They're blue blood head football coaches, yep. But it's frustrating to me when I see to where they were projected and where they are now, and the fact that they're still in this Coach of the Year conversation.
Well, I think we get caught up in preseason expectations versus performance, and we, because at Arkansas, you've way outperformed, at least in a lot of people's opinion, where Arkansas's at now, when a lot of people thought you'd win zero games this year. You've won three to this point. Sam Pittman's not on this list. It's frustrating. I think we put a lot of weight in that factor, that value of expectation versus reality versus actual performance. Is that how they should weight this? And that's got to be a factor in there, right? I mean, if you're expected to do one thing and you do another, shouldn't that be there? If you've outperformed expectation, I mean, that's how everything in life should be judged. You know, if you're expected to win 8 or 9 or 10, 9 or 10 or 11, you know, and you underperform, you shouldn't be on this list. And you're pointing out some guys that were expected to do a lot more than they have done, but you're on here because, A, they need some guys from every part of the country and some conference representation because they need this to have some validity on a national scale. And, again, it's just a watch list, but I think we got our it's under our crawl a little bit this morning because Sam's not on here.
And I wouldn't be as frustrated seeing this list because the majority, I would probably say 80 to 90% of these names are valid and should be in contention for Coach of the Year. But when you toss out Lincoln Riley of Oklahoma, you toss out Gus Malzahn at Auburn, Tom Herman at Texas, Clay Helton, who really hasn't done anything in his time at USC, those are the names that should irk you a little bit, particularly Gus Malzahn. Have no problem with Jimbo Fisher. Have no problem with Dan Mullen. Those two are probably – one of them is going to win probably SEC Coach of the Year. Sam is probably not going to win that. But I think that's where you should be frustrated as an Arkansas fan when you look at these guys, like you mentioned, the expectations. Oklahoma was, what, a top five team, top six team heading into the college football season? This was supposed to be the year for Sam Ellinger and Tom Herman. Not so much. Then you look at Gus Malzahn. I have no idea why he's on this list whatsoever. That's where the blue bloods of college football seemingly get all the glory, regardless of the expectations, regardless of the actual outlook. That, to me, is frustrating as an Arkansas fan because when you see something like this, and yes, you always bring up, well, it's more important to win games than it actually is to get awards and give the perception at games. But when you have stuff occur like the Darren McFadden stuff, the Heisman robberies, or this, or numerous other awards that could have been divvied out to your guy, I mean, it wears on you a little bit, and it should. It absolutely should. When you continuously see SEC commentators, college football commentators say, hey, Sam Pittman should be in contention for the SEC Coach of the Year. Some even went as far as to say, hey, not just SEC Coach of the Year, National Coach of the Year. And then he doesn't make a list of, what, 20 people? I mean, what are we doing here at this point?
I don't have every record, but how many coaches on this list have a losing record?
I can do this off the top of my head. I'm looking. There doesn't seem to be one on this list.
I think you have your answer, Judge.
But, okay, then what's the point of even having preseason polls then? What's the point of even, like, unless you're just expected to?
TV needs preseason polls because the matchups aren't – that's why we don't have the college football playoff rankings until later in the year. And those are the only ones that matter. These other polls, these coaches' polls and AP, they're meaningless. They're only there so CBS and ESPN can claim and say we have number 8 versus number 4 tonight on ESPN at 6 o'clock. They're meaningless. They hold no water. The AP poll at the end of the day, what does it mean?
What's looked at, I mean, you can't say that the College Football Playoff Committee does not look at these because they do look at these polls. They've mentioned committee members have literally talked about how they look at these polls as a point of reference. So they do mean something as far as that goes.
But what is the only ranking that matters is at the end of the year, and it's the College Football Playoff
But
ranking.
If all that plays into what that ranking is constituted in, so it does play a role. So it does.
Okay, a very minor role, but
I mean, what's the point if you don't have polls? Then what's the reference point for these committee members? Because not all these committee members, in fact, a lot of them.
I'm a big believer, and again, we just came through a very heated political season where polls were, you know, a lot of doubt into the polls. We'll just say that. Polls are just opinions. That's all they are. They're just compiled opinions. And you're just what we don't agree with is whoever compiled this opinion of who is the coach of the year. These are just opinions. These aren't facts.
Let me ask you something. So if they start – when they start getting into the closer awards when it comes to, like, the Broyles Award, when it comes to the Brandon Burlesworth Trophy, and if Grant Morgan or Hudson Clark – and I think Hudson's kind of dropped off a little bit, but if Grant is not at least in the conversation for the Burlesworth Award, or if Barry Odom is not in conversation for the Broyles Award, is that validated, or is that not frustrating to you as an Arkansas fan?
Well, it may be frustrating, but you just, you know, you don't agree with that committee's opinion, that collective body of people that vote in that poll's opinion.
I just think when it comes to
– and maybe it robs you of an opportunity at some point.
Well, you know? When it just comes to – Arkansas is always going to get the short end of the stick from the NCAA, the SEC, and this is just another case example of that. When you have a guy who has clearly outperformed expectations to this point, it's not even close. There was guys like you mentioned said he wouldn't win a game. Wouldn't win a game. Yeah. They've won three. He's got to be at least presented in this conversation to this point. Hour number three on the way. Richard Davenport joins us next on a Recruiting Thursday brought to you by Breeden RV.
Make a hot spring spa part of your day-to-day routine and discover what it means to get more out of your day. Burton Pools and Spas is your local hot spring spa dealer. Hot Spring Spas, the number one spa brand, helps reduce stress, ease muscle pain, and helps you get a better night's sleep. Invest in yourself and get more out of each day with a new hot spring spa at Burton.
When you're looking for outdoor power equipment, head to R-Track, where we've got the area's best selection of tractors and mowers. Check out our side-by-side UTVs, Argo Amphibious XTVs, and Hammerhead Go-Karts. We rent professional quality equipment and service everything we sell. Stop by today. Get the R-Track advantage.
Off I-40 at exit 58 at 219 East Taylor Road in Clarksville. You can check out their inventory online at rtrack.com.
This is Pastor Heath from Woodland. I know some of these ads make you glad, but most probably make you mad. The reason is people believe the lie that heals is better than the truth that hurts. Our purpose at Woodland is to risk the hurt by exposing the lies so you can be wise unto salvation. If you'd like to know more, check out our website, woodlandpeople.church. There you can download our app and listen to our podcast. That's woodlandpeople.church.
Frankfro Furniture Super Black Friday Blowout Sale, 2 p.m. to 6 p.m. Thanksgiving Day, 8:30 a.m. to 6 p.m. Friday the 27th, and 6:30 to 5:30 p.m. Saturday the 28th. For example, Catnapper Reclining Sofa and Love, regular $22.50, on sale finance price $18.22, cash price $16.70. Store-wide sale, all furniture, bedroom furniture, and mattresses on sale. 3 days only at Frankfro Furniture Super Black Friday Sale. Best seats in the house.
Tommy Kraft here. When it came time for new gates and some fence repairs at my home, the Fence Man was my first call. The Fence Man does it all, from large commercial jobs to small residential repairs. Wood privacy fence, vinyl fence, commercial or residential chain link, even custom wrought iron fencing. 479-782-3936. 18 months, same as cash financing with approved credit, is now available. If it involves fencing, the Fence Man does it. The Fence Man. He ain't afraid of no work. 479-782-3936.
Breeden RV in Van Buren is having their last sale of the year. Despite COVID-19's best effort, we are still getting in new trailers in weekly, and they are marked down as soon as they hit the lot. Browse Breeden RV selection of Forest River, Dutchman, Thor, and Coachman products and pick out the best fit for you. You can buy with ease knowing that your new purchase comes with free maintenance for life. Once you're ready to hibernate for the winter, bring your camper into us for deluxe winterization special starting at just $99. Breeden RV will work on all makes and models, and don't forget that all their accessories are installed for free. The Breeden RV Center in Van Buren, your friends in the RV business.
Do you own apartment complexes, condos, and rental property? Then you have made a great investment. Now make another great decision by calling Trinity Multifamily to help you maximize your return. Trinity Multifamily offers full-service property management, marketing, leasing, sales, and all the services to make your cash flow. Take the hassles and frustrations out of ownership and call Trinity Multifamily at 479-452-1817 or online at trinitymultifamily.com. Trinity Multifamily, your teammate in the real estate game.
Hi, I'm Kelly Smith, owner of Dixie Digital Imaging. Would printing from your phone or tablet make your life easier? Are you emailing files to yourself so that you can print them from your desktop or laptop? The Xerox VersaLink and AltaLink lines of network printers and multifunction printers will natively print using your phone's built-in capabilities. Apple AirPrint and Google Cloud Printing just work. To order yours today, give us a call at 783-6600 or visit dixiedigital.com. Dixie Digital Imaging, bringing document innovations to the River Valley.
Tri-Hill Turf offers the highest quality turf and pest services. Hey, you say those are big words. Well, let's see. Tri-Hill Turf and Pest has a company agronomist, state and nationally certified technicians, free soil testing, and they even have precision GPS guided application equipment. Now that's high tech. For over 30 years, Tri-Hill Turf and Pest has used the latest application technology, and they strive for turf and pest excellence. They are your local turf and pest experts. Call the local team at 782-0404. Tri-Hill Turf and Pest.
Oh my gourd, folks. Larry Rath here from Rath Auto Resources. This month, I want to say thanks. So I'm on a mission to make car buying easy as pie and help you snag a sweet deal on one of our Rath Road Ready vehicles, each one hand-picked and inspected in our Meineke Car Care Center. This month, you could drive a nicer, newer car and save up to $4,150. That's a lot of dough. So if your old ride is flaky, crusty, burnt, or rusty, don't let it squash your happiness. Trade it for a nicer, newer car now, even if you still owe money, and save up to $4,150. Plus, my For the People approval process makes financing your nicer, newer car easy as pie. Keeping the car you have? Get it ready for winter in our Meineke Car Care Center with half-off brakes and buy three, get one free on all tires. Deals this delicious won't last long, so visit us today at Arkansas's favorite used car dealer, Rath Auto Resources and the Meineke Car Care Center, 4515 Towson Avenue, Fort Smith, or online, rathauto.com.
ESPN Arkansas weather.
Sunshine with us today. Our high this afternoon will be into the lower 70s tonight, mainly clear to partly cloudy and overnight low near 50. Friday, we're back to partly to mostly sunny skies, our high low 70s. Saturday, clouds with a chance of a few showers, our high near 70. I'm Sally Russell with your forecast on ESPN Arkansas.
Hey, it's Mike Greenberg. Be sure to listen to The Morning Rush with Ty Richardson and Tommy Kraft every weekday, 6 to 9.
KERX, Paris, Fort Smith.
Hey, we can't make you a morning person, but we can make your mornings.
ESPN
95.3. Here's what you want to tell me. Coach, thank you for paving the way for line coaches to become head coaches. And he had told me that in the SEC meeting. We talked about a couple of things. He wanted to know how COVID was. I said, we're fine. He said, okay, man, we're going to be ready to play. And I congratulate him on what a great job he was doing.
Hey, this is Darren McFadden. You're listening to The Morning Rush.
Live from the Busch Light Studios.
Busch.
You're causing a major disturbance on my time.
If I'm here and you're here, doesn't that make it our time?
On your favorite Arkansas sports talk station. Streaming live from
hitthatline.com.
There's a lot of lions, tigers, and bears, but they ain't but one Razorback. Number one.
This is The Morning Rush.
Borderline erotic.
With Ty Richardson.
I'm Ty.
That's cool. I can dig it.
And Tommy Kraft.
Do I look happy?
What's wrong?
Lloyd!
The Morning Rush starts right now.
Hour number three of The Morning Rush. It is a recruiting Thursday, and we're going to talk to Richard Davenport coming up in just one sec. And it is brought to you by Breeden RV this morning. The Breeden RV Center in Van Buren, home of free maintenance for life. When you head over there, you're going to get quality customer service, and Ransom and his crew have the best selection, whether it's Thor, Forest River, Dutchman, Thor, Coachman, and so many more. And their trailers and RVs are marked down as soon as they hit the lot. So stop on by and see them at the Breeden RV Center in Van Buren, your friends in the RV business. Sam Pittman in the SEC teleconference yesterday was talking about their numbers heading up to the Arkansas-LSU game. He said, we are still within the number ratio and look forward to playing. And we have an adequate number of people to play. That same thing he said to Ed Ogeron. But you do wonder, Tommy, who is not going to be participating as of Saturday.
You know, roll call on Saturday when Clay and Tom and everyone gets in the binoculars and starts trying to check players off on the two deep and the roster is going to be very important, because we know that that Arkansas is going to be most likely missing some players, and it's just a matter of which players you are missing. So no question that contact tracing and COVID is going to play a factor for Arkansas on Saturday.
No question about it. And I'm just wondering, like, you keep getting antsy a little bit. You're getting closer and closer to the game, and you hear rumors, you hear this, you hear that. And you're like, oh, this is not good. Like, I was extremely confident in the Arkansas Razorbacks' chances against LSU, and now the pendulum's starting to swing the other way, in my opinion.
Yeah, you don't wish COVID on anyone. You don't wish contact tracing. I think contact tracing's probably, in some ways, worse than the COVID because you're out, but you don't have it. So that's got to be more frustrating for the player and for the coach to some degree. And you got four more days, at least in some circles, you're out 14 days if you're on contact tracing. I don't know about with the players, but it's just got to be frustrating when, hey, I don't have symptoms, but I'm caught up in this because I sat 6 feet from someone in a classroom or a meeting room or whatever, but yet I feel fine and I'm testing negative.
Yeah, it's got to be really frustrating for a lot of these student-athletes that are really itching to play, especially in a rivalry game like this is, and might not be able to participate. Good news on the Arkansas basketball front last night. Isaiah Joe drafted 49th overall, second round, to the Philadelphia 76ers, and then Mason Jones signs a two-way deal with the Houston Rockets.
Great conversation about 45 minutes ago. We started with Eric Musselman, whose team starts in less than a week, or scheduled to start in less than a week. He talked about both of those guys, and if you missed any of that, you can catch that on our podcast today. I thought one of the big notes out of that, and you can hear that, is he said the majority of his team has tested positive at this point. So at this point, they don't have to test the vast majority of the people around their program any longer with basketball. So that's big news that he shared with us this morning.
And if you didn't get a chance to listen to it, make sure you are subscribed and listening to our Bud Light Seltzer Morning Rush podcast. That will be in it.
We are live at World of Wireless. 877-305-DISH is their number here. They're celebrating 25 years in business. We'll talk to Ben in just a little while. They've got some great gifts for you, including a Google Home Hub when you sign up for DISH and a $100 Visa gift card. Hey, if you're out, you got the kids dropped off, come by, see Ben, or just call him. 877-305-DISH. It's their 25-year anniversary sale. We're here to celebrate on the Morning Rush with World of Wireless.
Let's go to the phone lines and welcome in Rich in Davenport this morning. RD, what's up, man? I kind of want to start with a conversation we had earlier, the importance of Louisiana recruiting. We talk about Oklahoma, we talk about Missouri, we talk about Dallas, Texas, but I think when you look at some of the Louisiana kids that have come to school at Arkansas that have played football, you think about Scooter Harris, Anthony Lucas, Richard Smith, Devion Warren. I mean, how important is the state of Louisiana to Arkansas football?
You know, definitely in the past, it's been very important. You usually get anywhere from, on a given year, anywhere from 2 to 4, 6 kids from the state of Louisiana. So, it's been very, very productive state for Arkansas, like you noted. And it's going up against LSU, being able to beat those guys. I don't think it's a game changer, but it definitely helps with Louisiana kids, especially the kids that are, maybe being overlooked by LSU, but they're being recruited by others.
And I think that's always an interesting conversation when you have someone from another state that's going against the in-state school, this being Greg Brooks Jr. and Joe Fouché. Ed Ogeron was asked about that yesterday from Tom Murphy or Bob Holt. I'm forgetting the source. But, Richard, to go off that, how motivated are guys like Greg and Joe going against an in-state school that maybe didn't recruit them as hard as they should?
Well, they got a chip on their shoulder. There's no doubt about it, I'm sure. Probably, just about every Louisiana kid wants to go to LSU, like the vast majority of Arkansas kids want to go to Arkansas. So you feel slighted, and here's an opportunity to show, hey, you missed out. And I'm sure they're going to do whatever they can to point that out on Saturday.
I was making a point with Ty earlier that if we could ever get the south end of I-49 built in this state to connect – from Alma down to Texarkana and build that corridor, what a pipeline that might be. Actually, we think about it just for commerce and for the economy and transportation, but you think about it from a recruiting standpoint, that Northeast Texas, Northern Louisiana area, the ease to get to Fayetteville, I've never really thought about it till today about a recruiting angle, but that area right there might open up some doors to get to Fayetteville. Moms and dads and kids might be a lot more open to the idea of getting to Northwest Arkansas with the ease of that road if it could only get built in our lifetime, R.D.
Yeah, no, you're right. You're right. And heck, we lived that in our lifetime. Just, Van Buren, Alma to Fayetteville. Yeah. Just having to go that two lane for so many years and then to finally be able to have that. I mean, it's also life saving. Let's face it, to be able to drive on a four lane versus a two lane, and so many times it's just you dread driving. Anytime you're kind of regulated to a two lane, you just dread that trip versus a four lane. So it definitely would help.
Yeah, people might be willing to vote in a toll road or pay more tax if they thought it'd help football recruiting. That might be the angle for the governor or whoever to get the money raised is if they thought we could get some four and five stars in recruiting. That might be the play politically.
Yeah, you'd have some that are definitely on the no side or on the kind of on the fence, and they go, right, yeah, okay, let's do that.
Yeah, absolutely.
Talking with Richard Davenport here on Recruiting Thursday, brought to you by Breen RV. RD, we got a text earlier this morning. I think it's Dennis in Van Buren. He's asking, are there still any in-state recruits that the Hogs are looking at, like Mason Brotherton, Jaden Williams, who are trying to flip Drayden Norwood from Texas A&M?
Right now, I would probably say no. But, I know Arkansas continues to evaluate kids throughout the season, and who knows, there may be a late offer. But as of right now, I would definitely lean towards no. But you just can't say that 100% certainty.
Richard, we were talking about basketball and just kind of the football connection a little bit. Eric Musselman, when he came on with us, he was talking about the importance of Isaiah getting drafted last night, Mason signing that two-way deal with the Houston Rockets. How important is it for Arkansas to continue to have guys drafted or picked up by NBA teams to continue Eric Musselman's success on the recruiting trail?
Well, that and going forward, it definitely would help in recruiting because, every kid wants to go to the NBA. And if you're not producing NBA talent, they'll start looking at other schools that are. So you hope that Isaiah and Mason are successful on the next level, and you hope the next batch of guys that are NBA worthy do well and get drafted, and that kind of just kind of helps your recruiting, and you can just point to to a list of guys that have gone on to the NBA.
Yeah. When you look at the draft last night and you look at how the SEC performed, that was kind of, surprising to some degree to me. We were talking about four of the first 14 and none of them being Kentucky. Of course, they had Anthony Edwards out of Georgia early. You had Lewis out of Alabama. You had a player from Vanderbilt. So the SEC performed well in this draft and led the nation with the most picks of any conference with 12. So, Richard, it shows you, if you're a player out there and you're evaluating which league might be best suited for you, the SEC is certainly making its case that it's back as one of the best leagues in the Power Five in college basketball.
I guarantee you that wasn't overlooked by kids that are considering the SEC schools. There's no doubt about that. And then you so many times you hear in football, the SEC is only Alabama. And we all know that's not true. And the same can be said for basketball because Kentucky usually turns out so many NBA prospects, but for it to be distributed throughout the league, that kind of tells you a little bit more about the depth of the SEC, and kids look at that and, you know, think, hey, you know, the ACC's traditionally considered the top league in the nation, or, you know, the SEC is right up there with them.
Yeah, I mean, 12 from the SEC, 10 from the Pac-10, 8 overseas, 8 from the ACC, but, you know, had 2 that didn't go to college, 1 from JUCO. I mean, you can kind of go through the list. Anthony Edwards goes number 1 overall from Georgia, clearly a football school, not a great basketball tradition. To me, what I take out of this when you look through the disparity, 1 from a prep school, if you're a player and you can play, they're going to find you. So, I mean, go where you want to go. Go for play for the coach you want to play at. If you're a player, they're going to come find you, Richard.
No, there's no doubt about that.
I mean that's the bottom line. So
the word gets around. If you can play, the word gets around. The scouts come see you play. And, you know, as far as, you know, you're talking about Edwards, I was kind of surprised. I thought he might have dropped a little bit on that statement saying that, you know, that football was his main love. Because, man, I tell you what, in basketball, that 82-game schedule, it's a grind. To me, it's just like college football and most of the sports and on the next level. It's such a grind. You got to love that sport in order to be successful. And, you know, but who knows? I'm sure they did their homework, but that kind of surprised me a little bit.
You just wonder with, like, an Anthony Edwards, if he had chosen Duke or Kentucky or one of the big household names in college basketball, is his value with Nike or Under Armour or some of the equipment companies worth more? I mean, I don't think his value with the Timberwolves would be worth more, but would his value outside of basketball be worth more if he'd went somewhere other than Georgia to Duke, Kentucky, Kansas, UCLA, somewhere like that?
No, you make a good point. And those spaces, especially those the lottery pick guys, that's where they make a lot of money.
You're just on TV more at Duke than you are at Georgia, period. National TV.
Absolutely.
Sure.
Definitely. I mean, his profile nationally would be much higher.
Yeah.
Well, RD, before we let you go, I know that we talk football, we talk basketball recruiting, but I just want to let you know that you will probably see – I'll send you a picture this weekend. There's this new incredible wing place up in northwest Arkansas, and I just wanted to give you a heads up on that I will be devouring some hot wings this weekend that I'm sure you would enjoy as well.
Yeah, I always expect some food tweets from you each week, so I'll be looking forward to it.
I think my food tweets are more controversial sometimes than my sports opinions, but I guess that's the way she goes sometimes. So, all right, Richard,
everybody has an opinion on food now.
Exactly. Yeah.
Everybody.
Exactly right. Richard, we always appreciate your time on Recruiting Thursday, man, and we will talk next Thursday.
We'll see you guys. Have a good one.
All right, Richard Davenport with us every Thursday, Recruiting Thursday. We're brought to you in part by NWA Gold and Silver, Bentonville, Fayetteville, and also in Fort Smith. If you got gold or silver coins, jewelry, whether it's silver flatware, any of those items you got laying around the house, or you got them safely kept in a safety deposit box or in a gun safe, you wonder what they're worth or you wonder what you could get for them today, we'll take it to NWA Gold and Silver. These are the experts. These are the people that pay the most. And right now with gold prices, $1,900 an ounce, why not take those gold coins, those silver coins, and turn them into cash? Why take that jewelry that's sitting in your jewelry box that you're never going to wear again, the wife's pendant that's out of style that she's not going to wear anymore, and turn that into cash that's in your hands? Certainly here at the holidays, we could all use some extra bread in our palm right now. So do that at NWA Gold and Silver, Bentonville, Fayetteville, and Fort Smith. You'll find them at 1130 North Walton in Bentonville, Nelson's Crossing by Jason's Deli in Fayetteville, and you'll find them on Rogers Avenue in Fort Smith. That's NWA Gold and Silver. The people that pay the most.
Speaking of food, we do need to mention that we're about a week out from the taco contest between Jenkins and I, which I'm sure many of you are ecstatic about. Halftime of the Missouri football game, Matt Jenkins and I will be going head-to-head with who can eat the most hard tacos over
yes.
at Joe's Grill and Cantina. And you've been chirping a little bit, Jenkins.
That's not really chirping. It's more just speaking speaking in the inevitable. It's not a prediction. It's a spoiler of what's fixing to happen. But we still want people to come out and cheer you on because you need every help you can get.
We don't really have rules. I mean, this is kind of a deal we've organically created on our own here. It just kind of came up as you two were talking trash. So at some point, I mean, I've gotten the clearance from Wade over at Joe's to do this deal.
Okay.
So we're going to do it at halftime of the Missouri game. So you guys need to come up with, I mean, is this going to be a 5-minute, 10-minute deal? I mean, obviously halftime is about 15 minutes, so we can't go any longer than that because I'm not missing the game. So
I think we just as soon as halftime begins, you go. So we have the
I'd say either that or I'll like how many can you eat in 5 minutes or five or something like that.
I think halftime's a good lot because I mean we can only stuff a number down our goal at Jenkins in 5 minutes. But I think as soon as halftime begins, as soon as that clock hits zero, that begins our time, and as soon as they kick the ball off, that's our ending. So that's just straightforward. That's what, 20 minutes? 25 minutes? Is it 15?
I think it's about 15.
Okay,
minutes.
15's fine. Five's too short. We want to keep this thing going a little bit. But
see, here's the better question. Who's doing the postgame show that week? Because if it's me or you, that's going to be the ultimate question because I love eating tacos, don't get me wrong, and I will destroy you. But, I mean, that's a lot of tacos sitting on me doing 2 hours of postgame radio show.
I'm not going to be the one to complain. Unlike you, Jenkins, I can do a radio show despite – no, whatever the circumstances, if my stomach is full, if it's hungry, it doesn't matter
right
to me,
on.
Man.
Okay.
I can get after it.
No,
so
he's built different.
I'm built different.
Yeah, don't
you ever forget?
They're built different down at Little Rock Christian.
Don't you ever forget it? But yeah, that is something to be looking forward to as far as that goes. We are looking forward to this LSU Arkansas game this weekend, and I know that as far as the game goes, I mean, this is the rivalry you look forward to every single year. No more Texas. I know you get to play Texas. This upcoming year, or excuse me, next year in Donald W. Reynolds Razorback Stadium, but it's not a yearly game. And hopefully
it's a makeup game for the one they stiffed you on.
And hopefully, knock on wood, you might get a chance to play them in a bowl game this year as well, maybe in the Texas Bowl or something. But I think when it comes –
I think because you're going to play them next year early, that's why you don't play them in a bowl
game
maybe this year.
You don't think they play that. But we'll see what ends up happening as far as Arkansas postseason is concerned. But I want to get back to just the connection between Ed Orgeron and Arkansas. Here's what Coach Orgeron had to say about Arkansas and his time in Fayetteville.
Yeah, I respect Arkansas, man. As you guys know, I spent 2 great years up there. I love the place. My first Division I coaching job. I learned a lot under Ken Hatfield. In fact, I'm going to see him before the game. Fred Goldsmith, Dean Webber, who hired me up there, just tremendous guys. They taught me how to be a football coach, so I respect that school. I respect the Arkansas program. I'm glad to see Sam Pittman is bringing it back. Obviously, when I played him, I'm not a fan, but I'm a fan. I've always been a fan of Arkansas. It was a great place.
So Mike Irwin always tells this story of when Coach Orgeron is a GA at the time at the U of A, and this is under Lou Holtz, and he's recording film for I don't remember the television company, and
KFSM,
and is that
Channel
it? And
5.
So he walks up there, and Coach says, and he kept saying, Coach says, cut it, and he's like, and Mike can't understand what Ed Orgeron is saying, and he's like, what? He's like, Coach said, cut it, and he literally can't understand what Ed Orgeron is saying. But while we like to make fun of Coach Orgeron for not necessarily knowing, it would be very hard to be his translator. There is no doubt that he seems to be a guy wherever he travels that a lot of people seem to enjoy his presence, whether it was at USC, Ole Miss, even though they didn't win football games, now at LSU. He is a really likable guy when it comes to that.
Well, he's a guy that he recruits well for a reason because he connects with people, and I think that's the commonality between him and Pittman, their ability to build the personal relationships, and that's what carries over to recruiting. And that's why both of them are tremendous recruiters.
So you're really excited about this game this weekend. As you heard, Ed Orgeron is excited to match up against one of his former teams as well.
All right, y'all were talking noise about Joe's Grill and Cantina. If you're going to go watch the Arkansas-LSU game, you might want to get to Joe's Grill and Cantina and do that there this weekend. Dollar tacos and half-price apps and taps at Joe's Grill and Cantina this weekend, 3400 South 74th Street across from Harps. They'll be open early with some drink specials and be ready to go for the kickoff at 11 o'clock at Joe's Grill and Cantina.
That's going to be a fun time when Jenkins and I compete for that coming up. I want to get back to what was reported from Tom Murphy. Tom is going to be joining us at Change Times this morning because Mus came on early. Tom's going to be joining us at 8:45 this morning. The COVID numbers, they don't seem to be favoring you this week. That's a conversation we'll hit on next.
This is Recruiting Thursday on the Morning Rush, brought to you by Breeden RV, where your adventures begin.
Yes, sir!
Tommy Kraft here. When it came time for new gates and some fence repairs at my home, the Fence Man was my first call. The Fence Man does it all, from large commercial jobs to small residential repairs. Wood privacy fence, vinyl fence, commercial or residential chain link, even custom wrought iron fencing. 479-782-3936. 18 months, same as cash financing with approved credit, is now available. If it involves fencing, the Fence Man does it. The Fence Man. He ain't afraid of no work. 479-782-3936.
When you're looking for outdoor power equipment, head to R-Track, where we've got the area's best selection of tractors and mowers. Check out our side-by-side UTVs, Argo Amphibious XTVs, and Hammerhead Go-Karts. We rent professional quality equipment and service everything we sell. Stop by today. Get the R-Track advantage.
Off I-40 at exit 58 at 219 East Taylor Road in Clarksville. You can check out their inventory online at rtrack.com.
This is Pastor Heath from Woodland. I know some of these ads make you glad, but most probably make you mad. The reason is people believe the lie that heals is better than the truth that hurts. Our purpose at Woodland is to risk the hurt by exposing the lies so you can be wise unto salvation. If you'd like to know more, check out our website, woodlandpeople.church. There you can download our app and listen to our podcast. That's woodlandpeople.church.
Frankfro Furniture Super Black Friday Blowout Sale, 2 p.m. to 6 p.m. Thanksgiving Day, 8:30 a.m. to 6 p.m. Friday the 27th, and 6:30 to 5:30 p.m. Saturday the 28th. For example, Catnapper Reclining Sofa and Love, regular $2,250, on sale finance price $1,822, cash price $1,670. Store-wide sale, all furniture, bedroom furniture, and mattresses on sale, 3 days only at Frankfro Furniture. Super Black Friday Sale, best seats in the house.
Tommy Kraft here. When it came time for new gates and some fence repairs at my home, the Fence Man was my first call. The Fence Man does it all, from large commercial jobs to small residential repairs. Wood privacy fence, vinyl fence, commercial or residential chain link, even custom wrought iron fencing. 479-782-3936. 18 months, same as cash financing with approved credit, is now available. If it involves fencing, the Fence Man does it. The Fence Man. He ain't afraid of no work. 479-782-3936.
Return it fully disinfected to your driveway. Pickup and delivery is free for jobs $75 or more. Jobs less than $75 can be picked up and returned for a $10 fee. Let Jody's Auto Service Centers handle all your service and vehicle repair needs. Call 479-649-3399. Jody's Auto Service Center.
Deer hunters, it's prime time, and the Deer Woods are the place to be. Jelco Outdoors has all the supplies and gear to make your hunt one to remember. Men's, women's, and children's boots and clothing to keep you warm and dry. Tree stands, scents, calls, safety vests, firearms, archery. Jelco has it all for you. Best of luck to all hunters. Stay safe and remember, a great hunt begins at Jelco Outdoors, 4600 South Zero in Fort Smith.
In sports, success is measured in the number of points scored, in games won, and in championships earned. At Shelter Insurance, we measure success in the quality of our products and services, in our community support, and being there when you need us. In fact, 9 out of 10 people surveyed with a claim would recommend Shelter to a friend. Shelter Insurance. We're your shield. We're your shelter.
Ask Tiffany Newman in Mulberry or Warren Robertson in Alma about Shelter's home insurance.
River City Bistro is Fort Smith's favorite place for lunch and dinner. Open 7 days a week, both on the open-air patio and air-conditioned dining room for your safety and comfort. River City Bistro is locally owned and open weekdays 11 to 8, Saturdays 10 to 8, and Sundays 10 till 3. Want River City Bistro curbside to go? Just search on Facebook or Instagram for River City Bistro or go to rcbistro.com. River City Bistro, 7320 Rogers Avenue in the Stonewood Village Shopping Center.
homeowner.
Building a home can be stressful. This is true whether you're the homeowner or the contractor. Many times these issues result in a lawsuit. If you are a homeowner or a contractor and find yourself needing legal help, call the attorneys at Kevin Hickey Law Partner. With experience representing homeowners as well as non-payment or other issues that could arise during construction, contact Brad Hull or Kevin Hickey at 479-434-2414 in the River Valley or 479-802-6560 in Northwest Arkansas, or check them out at the web at artriallawyers.com.
0% financing for 84 months on all 2020 Buicks, GMC Terrains, and GMC Acadias at Harry Robinson Buick GMC. Get 0 for 84 months on the hottest selling Buick model, the Buick Encore, or 0 for 84 on the Buick Enclave, loaded with luxury and third row seating. 0% financing for 84 months on all 2020 Buicks, GMC Terrains, and Acadias at Harry Robinson Buick GMC. Exit 11 off of I-540 in Fort Smith.
ESPN 95.3. The Morning Rush with Ty Richardson and Tommy Kraft.
It is to Alex Collins straight up the middle, and Collins on the run. They won't catch him. Alex Collins is going to take it all the way to the house. Touchdown, Arkansas.
Follow the show on Twitter at HitThatLineAR and on Facebook and Instagram at HitThatLine.
We'll get back into the Arkansas-Louisiana conversation, how important it is, the state of Louisiana, for Arkansas football, and that's a conversation we'll take for just one sec. First, I want to tell you about Breeden RV, as it is a recruiting Thursday, and they are having their last sale of the year. They're getting in new trailers weekly and their new RVs weekly, and they are marked down as soon as they hit the lot. Plus, when you stop by and see Ransom and his crew, you're going to get free maintenance for life with everything new. And if you need to hibernate your trailer or RV for the winter, Breeden RV can do that as well. Winterization specials starting at just $99. They'll work on all makes and models at Breeden RV. So head over, stop by the Breeden RV Center in Van Buren, your friends in the RV business.
Ben at World of Wireless is with us. We are live at World of Wireless. They are celebrating 25 years in business this month. First of all, congratulations. It's hard for anyone to survive 25 years in today's world. And you're in the technology business, which is ever-evolving. Your business is ever-evolving. We were talking earlier in the show about you literally started selling bag phones 25 years ago, and here we are today. You got satellite systems. You got internet you sell. We're giving away Google Home Hubs. If I'd have told you 25 years ago you're going to sell hubs, you'd have thought hubcaps, not you'd say, what's a hub?
You know, speak to it, it does stuff for you.
And you said, what? You know, it's futuristic then, but here we are today. So congratulations, 25 years. Proud of you.
Thank you. And well, I've been in business longer than some of my employees are of age.
Well, this guy right here.
Yeah.
So, he'll be 26 next month. But
right on the money. So
We were opening in, like I said, 17-degree weather the day after Thanksgiving about 25 years ago. So you were about to come out of the womb.
Enter the world.
Yes.
Good old 1994. Yeah. What a year.
Not far.
What a year.
But, yeah, it's been exciting. We got the Dish products. We got the DirecTV products, all the internet services we offer. Just need to come see us at our new location. It's a new building. It's right at the corner of Church and kind of Highway 22. Rogers Avenue extends into Barling, right next to Frank Row Furniture. So,
yeah, so come by, and no matter where you're listening, whether it's Northwest Arkansas, east of the River Valley, south of the area, you can handle Dish or DirecTV services, internet services, anywhere someone's listening this morning.
Yeah, any rural area, go to our website, wowfastinternet.com, rural south of Greenwood, rural Charleston, Altus, Denning, we're expanding into Ozark area. Just give us a call, and we will take care of you.
Hey, we love being lazy, and we're in a lazy world anymore, and that's what these Google Home Hubs do. You can just sit back and be lazy and tell it to change the thermostat, change the channel on the TV, do so many things for you. That's what these hubs do, and you guys are getting into this home automation. You do the thermostats, you do the cameras, you do so many of the things that automate your home anymore, and I know a lot of people, particularly the upper end in age, those with seniority in our audience probably want some help with that stuff, and you guys do that.
We do that. We have installers. Dish is partnered with Google, and as a premier retailer, we do that. It's hard when you go to the big box stores and look at them because the stuff doesn't work. We actually have the thermostat working and the cameras working and the hub working, and it integrates with the hopper. So it's been a good product.
You understand this stuff? You got any of that stuff working at your house?
I have a thing or two at our we have a lot of technology at our house, so we have a thing or two as far as that goes. So
I got my new dish system hooked in with my Alexa, so now I can tell Alexa to change the TV channel. Yeah. And my kids think that's the neatest
thing in the
world.
Can you tell it to change the rib, turn the ribs over on
the
grill?
I have not figured that out.
And yet. I would be remiss if I didn't sneak in. What's the sport I always got to sneak in?
Soccer. In our defense, we did speak about soccer yesterday and the Arkansas soccer
team.
That's
what I was going to say. They played tonight. I want to remind people on the SEC Network.
Yep, playing South Carolina.
South Carolina. Coach Colby Hale has done really well there.
We got that in yesterday.
And he's a unique coach and a lot of people. So here's my real quick perspective so you can move on to the next segment.
Who's going
to
win?
Well,
Arkansas, right?
I mean, South Carolina's a good team, but Arkansas's
number
six.
Now, that was the final last year, right?
Wasn't
that the SEC?
Yeah, I think you're right, yes.
It was.
Yes. And Coach Hale's unique from a standpoint. 50% of goals – in soccer, more than 50% around the world are scored on what's called set play, where the play stopped and you all can line up and do something. And I watched him on a pod or a live Facebook with the Arkansas State Soccer Association this year, and he practices set plays more than any coach I've ever heard of. And I've been coaching for 20-something years and playing for 45 years, and that's one of his big things. So when you score more than half your goals on set plays, a lot of times coaches will spend – and you played soccer, Ty –
I did.
One practice a year, a couple of practices, maybe 30 minutes here. He spends a lot of his time on set plays, and all four goals they scored the other night were on set plays in the first half. So sometimes you got to be smarter than the rest of the crowd. He's kind of been unique from that standpoint. So, but they're on the SEC Network, and I coached ladies soccer around here, and so hopefully people will watch it.
Yep, we'll check that out. Well, hey, you've been a great teammate with us, great partner with us for a number of years, and thanks for having us out this morning. And again, congratulations on 25 years. If you need satellite, you need help with internet, you need anything with technology, Ben's your guy, 877-305-DISH.
Or go to wowfastinternet.com.
There you go. Forgot that. So, hey, thanks again, buddy.
Thanks.
All right. Ben at World of Wireless, 877-305-DISH.
Wanted to get this in here real quick as we get ready to talk with Tom Murphy. Hopefully he'll have an update for us as far as the Arkansas football COVID numbers are concerned. But Richard Smith, former Razorback, is an avid listener of the Morning Rush, and he was listening this morning. We're texting back and forth a little bit. And, Tommy, he agrees with you about the I-49 from Alma to Texarkana. He says, being from Shreveport, Louisiana, it was one of the points that Coach Nutt and Fitz Hill sold me on. And 21 years later, it not only benefits the U of A football, but the state, and it would help out a lot with Louisiana and Texas. So any upgrades that Arkansas can have to their highways or streets or anything like that is going to help the circulation and the appeal to recruits coming from out of state to the University of Arkansas.
You shouldn't build it for recruiting, but recruiting would be one of the benefits
yeah. No question.
But if you want to build it for recruiting, that's just one of the many reasons why you should get I-49 done.
Go right ahead and do that. All right, Tom Murphy of the Arkansas Democrat Gazette joins us next. Folks, stay with us. It's the Morning Rush.
We're trying to outwork everybody in recruiting.
This is Recruiting Thursday on the Morning Rush, brought to you by Breeden RV.
When you're looking for outdoor power equipment, head to R-Track, where we've got the area's best selection of tractors and mowers. Check out our side-by-side UTVs, Argo Amphibious XTVs, and Hammerhead Go-Karts. We rent professional quality equipment and service everything we sell. Stop by today. Get the R-Track advantage.
Off I-40 at exit 58 at 219 East Taylor Road in Clarksville. You can check out their inventory online at rtrack.com.
This is Pastor Heath from Woodland. I know some of these ads make you glad, but most probably make you mad. The reason is people believe the lie that heals is better than the truth that hurts. Our purpose at Woodland is to risk the hurt by exposing the lies so you can be wise unto salvation. If you'd like to know more, check out our website, woodlandpeople.church. There you can download our app and listen to our podcast. That's woodlandpeople.church.
Frankfro Furniture Super Black Friday Blowout Sale. 2 p.m. to 6 p.m. Thanksgiving Day. 8:30 a.m. to 6 p.m. Friday the 27th. And 6:30 to 5:30 p.m. Saturday the 28th. For example, Catnapper Reclining Sofa and Love, regular $22.50, on sale, finance price $18.22, cash price $16.70. Store-wide sale. All furniture, bedroom furniture, and mattresses on sale. 3 days only at Frank Rowe Furniture. Super Black Friday sale. Best seats in the house.
Tommy Kraft here. When it came time for new gates and some fence repairs at my home, the Fence Man was my first call. The Fence Man does it all, from large commercial jobs to small residential repairs. Wood privacy fence, vinyl fence, commercial or residential chain link, even custom wrought iron fencing. 479-782-3936. 18 months, same as cash financing with approved credit, is now available. If it involves fencing, the Fence Man does it. The Fence Man. He ain't afraid of no work. 479-782-3936.
A month, TV starting at $32.95 and fiber phone at $29.95. Sign up is underway. Call 1-833-4WAVE-RC or check online at signup.waveruralconnect.com and find out too about how you could win a free year of internet. Arkansas Valley Electric and Wave Rural Connect, changing the communities we serve.
It's time to plan the Christmas party for your business or family. And the place to make it a special and memorable time is at Doe's Eat Place in Fort Smith. Award-winning steaks and atmosphere, along with the largest selections of adult beverages in the River Valley, await your evening. When you think about what to get that hard-to-impress boss or family member, gift certificates from Doe's are sure to impress. Don't delay. Call Doe's Eat Place at 784-9111. That's 784-9111. Doe's Eat Place, open 5 till 9 Tuesday through Thursday and 5 till 10 Friday and Saturday.
Frank Rowe Furniture Super Black Friday Blowout Sale, 2 p.m. to 6 p.m. Thanksgiving Day the 26th, 8:30 a.m. to 6 p.m. Friday the 27th, and 8:30 a.m. to 5:30 p.m. Saturday the 28th. For example, Catnapper Reclining Sofa and Loves, regular $22.50, on sale finance price $18.22, cash price $16.70. Store-wide sale, all furniture, bedroom furniture, and mattresses are on sale. 3 days only at Frank Rowe Furniture Super Black Friday Sale. Best seats in the house.
They say, trust the process. But if enjoyment isn't part of that process, don't trust the process. Michelob Ultra, superior light beer. Enjoy responsibly. AB Michelob Ultra Light Beer, St. Louis, Missouri.
New Bud Light Seltzer?
Yep.
A hard seltzer with a hint of fruit flavor?
Yep.
Can I try one?
Yep.
That tastes great.
Told ya.
Bud Light Seltzer, unquestionably good. Anheuser-Busch Bud Light Seltzer. IRC Beers, beer in Texas, St. Louis, Missouri.
Have you been looking for your next place to call home and just haven't found the right one? Then it's time to check out the properties at Trinity Multifamily. With a variety of apartments, duplexes, townhomes, and houses, there is surely one to fit your needs. Whether it's in the River Valley, Northwest Arkansas, or Central Arkansas that you are looking at, they have you covered. Give them a call today. Trinity Multifamily, 479-452-1817. That's 479-452-1817. Or online at trinitymultifamily.com to search rental properties near you.
Always get more at Orr.
We always put the customer first at Orr Chevrolet in Fort Smith. Since 1924, the Orr family of dealerships has grown based on one simple principle. Give the customer more money for their trades and give them a lower price on their new vehicle. It's a simple concept, really, but one that very few dealers honor anymore. Hey, we know you paid a lot of money for your vehicle, and Orr Chevrolet wants to pay you the maximum amount for it today. Then we'll give you an awesome price on a new Chevrolet. But we're not done giving you more. Included with any new vehicle sold, Orr Chevy will also give you a lifetime powertrain warranty, 2 years of free maintenance, and free car washes for life. So come get a lower price and more money for your trade today at Orr Chevrolet on Auto Park Drive in Fort Smith and 24/7 at OrrChevyFS.com. Chevy, find new roads.
You always get more at Orr.
ESPN 95.3.
Good morning to the Morning Rush, everybody.
Smith on the call. He's got a big hole. There he goes. Smith at the 40, to midfield, to the Florida 40, to the 30, to the 20, to the 10. Touchdown, Arkansas. Touchdown, Arkansas.
All your favorite podcasts in one place. The Hit That Line Podcast Network. Just search Hit That Line wherever you listen to podcasts.
So the guy that broke the news earlier this week is Tom Murphy, and does a fantastic job for the Arkansas Democrat Gazette and Whole Hog Sports. And he was kind enough to shift his time this morning to allow Eric Musselman to join us. And we're going to talk with him the latest, what he's been hearing about the Arkansas football team, coming up in just one sec.
Hey, if you're making some weekend plans, maybe you want to get to River City Bistro and have some brunch before the game this weekend, you can do that. They open at 10 o'clock both Saturday and Sunday at 7320 Rogers Avenue in the Stonewood Village. Or maybe you're making Friday evening plans. River City's a great place for date night or taking the family out for a great meal. They got patio space, so if you're more comfortable with outdoor dining, they can do that. Or maybe you want meals to go because of COVID numbers and things right now. Hey, they get it, and they got great family packs, or you can use their menu that's online at RC Bistro. They got spots where you can pull up and never even leave your car. So whatever you're most comfortable with, hey, RC Bistro is going to take care of you. The patio, they got the heaters out there, so even on a cooler night, you'll be comfortable. Whether it's brunch on the weekends, dinner at night, indoors, outdoors, to go, they are ready for you under any circumstance at River City Bistro. Again, order online, rcbistro.com. Find them on Facebook. You can read their menus. It's a great Pittsburgh-style deli, but with so many other things, one of the great places to eat with a unique menu you'll find in the River Valley. That's River City Bistro, rcbistro.com online, 7320 Rogers Avenue in the Stonewood Village Shopping Center.
Tom, I know you've been really busy all week, so I appreciate you making some time for us. We've heard from Sam Pittman a few times this week, meeting with the Arkansas media on Monday, talking with the SEC media yesterday during the SEC teleconference, and we heard from Ed Orgeron. Ed Orgeron said that it still looks like they're going to be ready to play. How concerned do you think Hunter Yurecek and Sam Pittman are with their numbers come Saturday?
Well, certainly mildly concerned, because when you have an outbreak, you don't know how long it takes maybe for someone to test positive. And so they'll be taking some tests today and getting results tomorrow that could change things. And, you know, from what I understand, there's a decent number of folks who've been in, who have to be in quarantine because of this. And when Nate Allen asked Sam Pittman yesterday on the SEC teleconference, did he feel confident that they had plenty of backups at certain positions and stuff? There was a long pause before Sam Pittman answered, "We have adequate numbers." So he didn't seem very, you know, happy at all with, you know, the fact that they're down in numbers. And, you know, for them, you look at this, it's a winnable game. They haven't had the boot in many years. And now this hits, and so, you know, it lessens the chance. In fact, I think it swung the betting line over to make LSU the favorite during the course of the week.
Yep. No, you're exactly right, Tom. The betting line started out, Arkansas opened as a three-point favorite. It's since moved to 2.5 in favor of the LSU Tigers. And Tommy made a good point earlier this week talking about, I don't think people bet millions and millions of dollars on the LSU Tigers. It's wild to think how much intel and information that Vegas seems to get. And you put two and two together, my guess is they probably had some inside information on the COVID numbers at Arkansas.
That very well may be the case, but I'll tell you, much like Tennessee having an open date and looking fresh at the start of that game and like on point, had a good game plan and controlled the first half, LSU is in, you know, they're not having a good year. They're 2-3. But for them, this is about as a fresh a start, you know, and renewed enthusiasm. Terrace Marshall spoke to the team on Monday about, hey, we got to stay focused. They got their numbers are going back on the upswing after having a lot of quarantining the week before and losing their game against Bama. So when you look at like the seesaw scales of momentum, LSU's seemingly on the upswing. And even though it's a road game, the weather's nice. They don't seem to play here when it's dark, dreary, cold, you know, icy rain, stuff like that. But they like the warm weather, and I think they're going to get the warm weather. So that's why Arkansas is now an underdog in this game. That and the fact that LSU just has great talent, and even though it's really young and they've been really exploited defensively this year, they've had a chance to hone their schemes a little bit for the Razorbacks.
Arkansas has managed to avoid any postponements to this point. LSU has obviously not been successful in that column after losing their Alabama game. Also, the Florida game's been moved to the 12th for them.
Yeah.
I guess Arkansas, in theory, could play LSU on the 19th if this game doesn't make this weekend, couldn't they, Tom?
You know, I haven't looked at it that closely, but I know that they still have games against, I think it's Ole Miss and A&M.
Well,
Florida,
Ole Miss is
Alabama.
On the 5th, and they got Florida scheduled for the 12th. I mean, LSU obviously is, you know, not going to play Alabama on the 19th if they're in the SEC championship. So, yeah. I guess in theory, Arkansas and LSU, if this game's not able to be played this weekend, could go on the schedule on the 19th.
I suppose it's open for them, and I'm sure they're trying to get the Alabama game in before then because that's Alabama's very likely in the SEC championship game. So I guess it's a possibility. Now, when I did talk to Hunter Yurecek on it was Monday, I suppose, he said that at that point there had been no discussions of moving any of their games. But circumstances between then and now, like you say, could cause something else.
Yeah, because, you know, at some point the league is going to have discussions or at least, consider the possibility if this continues to worsen, if they want to get all five home games for all these teams in or as many as possible, do you move the SEC championship weekend back to the 26th? And I think in a year where flexibility and everybody working towards a common end has been at least a talking point, I wonder if another week or two, if we're a week or two away from that being a talking point.
You know, it very well could be, Tommy, and that's what Hunter Yurecek also told me, was that the one thing that they've gotten out of this season is everyone has had to learn to be flexible, and they're trying to accommodate things for all 14 teams. You know, Arkansas is the team that took it on the chin with the scheduling. There's no doubt about that, drawing Georgia and Florida. If you get Kentucky or South Carolina or Vanderbilt this year, the way they're playing, that looks like a W for them. And then, of course, they had the Auburn game taken away from them from an officiating standpoint. So, you know, they could already be looking at having five wins now instead of three.
Tom Murphy with us here on the Morning Rush. Tom, you brought up the Tennessee game, which I thought was interesting because heading into that football game with Tennessee coming on off a bye, the storyline was this is the game that the Vols can turn their season around, similar to what they did last year after starting out really slow, especially losing against Georgia State. And it looked to be the case that was trending in that direction the first half. Then Arkansas beat their brains out in the second. For LSU, you mentioned Terrace Marshall's players-only meeting. Are they looking at this game as one where they can turn their season around by beating the Razorbacks?
Well, I certainly think so. And it's, you know, it's your self-respect. I mean, they're the defending national champion. They were ranked number 6 to start the season. And even though people knew they had suffered a lot of personnel losses, they still thought very highly of them. And they got, you know, whipped at home by Mississippi State, who since then, thanks to Barry Odom and Arkansas, people have, you know, learned how to defend them a whole lot better. Mm-hmm. So they're trying to, you know, restore their name, restore their identity. And I'll tell you, that Tennessee game, since you brought it back up, to me that's like a microcosm of Arkansas' season. You know, started off, you know, slowly and they're behind. But they showed, A, they can make changes at halftime that help, you know, basically throttle the Tennessee run game. And they get some big plays and they kind of take over in the trenches and they wind up winning the game. And so that's kind of who Arkansas is right now. They're not as big as they want to be. They're not as powerful and strong as they want to be, but they're heading that way. And Sam said it last night on his radio show, the O-line just keeps getting better and better. And you're seeing now that they're competing better on both sides of the line. And that's the type of team they want to be. And that's why the run game has picked up in recent weeks.
Tom, I think that when you look at what LSU had at quarterback in Miles Brennan, whether it was Ed Ogeron, Scott Linehan, Steve Ensminger, they were confident in Brennan. But now they're having to deal with a little difference with Mac Johnson and TJ Finley. Now, Ed Ogeron said yesterday on the teleconference that they hadn't fully decided who was going to be quarterback starting against Arkansas. I would bet money it's probably going to be TJ Finley. What kind of matchup problems do Finley and Johnson present to the Razorbacks come Saturday?
Well, I think you're right because Johnson hasn't had near the practice time. Mm-hmm. He missed last week, and Finley started the other game. It's just that he's still a freshman, and he still makes some mental errors. And Arkansas is in position, I think, if they've got the personnel to do this, to try to do some confusing things, maybe get pressure on him. But I guarantee you Finley's legs are going to be part of this equation that they've, like, they put things out there. Okay, if they're going to drop eight, and the guys are covered, you know, we can run our quarterback, and he's a huge dude, and he's got good wheels. So I guarantee you that's going to be a bigger part of LSU's scheming for this game. He's got a big arm. I haven't seen a whole lot of clips from him, but he had a big super game with great completion percentage against South Carolina, and then not so good against Auburn. So I would think that U of A coaches have looked at how Auburn schemed them up and will try to implement some of the same things and try to keep Finley contained because they don't need him running free on the perimeter.
Tom, good stuff as always, man. We appreciate you shifting your times this morning, and we'll recap it all on Monday, see what happens between the Tigers and the Razorbacks.
You bet, guys. See what happens on Saturday. Could be very interesting.
Big game for Arkansas and LSU this weekend, so good stuff from Tom Murphy as always. Want to remind everyone, we had Eric Musselman on this morning at 7:15, Bud Light Seltzer Morning Rush podcast. If you hadn't get a chance to listen to it, it will be on that. We'll also incorporate some of our other segments and interview part of that as well. And you brought up the important tidbit, probably the most important out of that interview.
Which was?
Do you want me to say it or you want to?
Well, I don't know. I thought...
Well, you said it was clearly the most important, that the most of his...
Oh, out of Musselman's
yeah,
interview.
Not Tom's. No, I was setting you up there.
So. Oh, about the fact that the majority of the team is already tested positive. So that tells me that the Arkansas basketball program is ready to move forward with the season and probably not going to miss games based on what we know right now.
Yeah.
Hey, thanks again to Ben, World of Wireless. Stop in and see him. Great guys here at World of Wireless. They can take care of you with Dish, DirecTV, anything you need at World of Wireless.
Should be a good football Friday tomorrow. Clay Henry joins us at 7 for Tommy, Ben, Ty, and Jenkins. We'll talk then.
Hi, this is Jan. Thanks for calling Toyota.
Hi, Jan. I heard Toyotathon is on.
It sure is. We've got great year-end deals on Camry, RAV4, Tundra, and more.